this afternoon for the Rangers of Northwestern Oklahoma. Clarkson, straight drop, now forced out of the pocket. In trouble, sack! There it finally is. We've been waiting on that sack, and it is big Rovell Carter.
Well, how the you know, he's been getting away from a lot of them. That time Rovell Carter doesn't get his arms on him. He just kind of wraps him up and lays down on top of him. You're not getting away that time.
The first half, Hayden Mallory scales behind him. Mallory's going to pass, got time, going to the end zone, intercepted! It goes back to Ouachita! Coming up with it, Hayden Laster, the senior, out of Warren.
Laster with the interception in the end zone, and he played that one perfectly.
Hayden Lassiter, the senior out of Warren, is his holder. Here we go, snap, hold, kick, trying to get there. It is good! It's good! It's good!
Oh, don't you love this celebration on the Ouachita side? Everybody with their hands in the air saying it is good. Gabe Goodman from Arkadelphia nailed it.
There's Edwards back, and there he may go! 45-50, 45-40, 35-30, 25-20, 15, 10, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Promised Land, touchdown. He just went all the way. He went 72 yards. Second down, 10 yards needed for a first down. Now Connor Flanagan goes in motion right to left. Out of the shotgun, called quarterback keeper, running room, 30, 25, 20. Zaylin Falls, Justin Dean deep for Ouachita. After 21 months away, Ouachita football is back. Falls at the 6, cuts over to the 10, the 15, the 20, the 25, the 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, 45, 40. Hits the far sideline to the 30. He's to the 20. He's to the 10. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Promised Land. No flags down. Kendall Gibbons right up the middle. First down, Ouachita. He's going. He's going. He's still going. He's going to the promised land. It's Kendall Gibbons. It's a touchdown, Ouachita. Other side. That's the wide side of the field protect this time. He looks this way. Can't find anybody. Sack! Back at the 29-yard line, it was Damian McDonald. Going to be the direct snap to T.J. Cole. Isaac Edwards set to his left. Cole looking up the middle of the field, finds running room as he cuts back right. He's going to be to the 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Promised Land. No flags down. Touchdown, T.J. Cole. Touchdown, Ouachita.
Well, he just got around that edge, Rex, and once he got to that edge, you knew he was going.
Tigers trailing 21 to nothing, but with a second and 7 now, with their deepest penetration so far at the 33. T.J. Cole, good running room, gets away at the 20, the 15, 10, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Promised Land, touchdown, T.J. Cole. The Tigers are finally on the board. They set on the near hash mark. They are going to pass. Looking, Morse has time. It's batted in the air, and it's intercepted. It is intercepted by Ouachita. Coming up with it on the first possession, Terrell Gibson. Touchdown, Ouachita.
Layup at the buzzer. Is it going to be an inside the Parker? Yes, it is.
received by White. His communication, and Tigers win!
And they're going to send around Allen. Is it going to be an inside the Parker? Yes, it is!
Court to the three-point line. Thornton underneath to Van Zandt. Layup at the buzzer. It's good. It's good. Ouachita storms the court.
Hello and welcome to this special playoff edition of the Captain Henderson House pregame show on OSDN. I'm Chase Hartzell, joined by Chris Gay. And Chris, it's going to be an exciting atmosphere today at Cliff Harris Stadium. First postseason game since 2019 for the Tigers at home.
Yeah, and the first time we ever get to see Northwest Missouri State. And, you know, obviously it's been since 2019 since Ouachita has been in the playoffs. And you can feel it on campus. It's electric and you can feel it. You know, at the stadium, it's just an amazing atmosphere.
Tigers are looking to roll off the momentum of an instant classic win at Carpenter Haygood Stadium over the Henderson State Reddies. A battle of the ravine to remember. We've seen a lot of those in recent years, but this one especially memorable, an overtime win, 40-37.
Well, and the miraculous comeback, you know, going into overtime, what, two touchdowns and like 3-4 minutes of play there at the very end. I mean, that's improbable, but not impossible, because Ouachita got it done.
And Ouachita will be looking to bring their A game this week again against truly one of the blue bloods of Division II football. This is a program that has really become, you know, for the playoffs for them has become a normalcy. In fact, it's a rarity when you see the Bearcats not in the playoffs. Northwest Missouri State, this is the 18th year in a row where they've been in the playoffs. You look at those six national championship banners. They've got 31 conference championship banners to go along with. This is a team that's used to winning, and they're going to be looking to do that again on the road today.
Yeah, and this is a team that has been in the playoffs, like you said, for 18 consecutive years and has led the conference in championships. But regardless, they haven't won since 2016. It's been 6 years since they've won a championship. So this is still, you know, kind of a new territory. You know, they're you know, and I guess you could say a bit of a cold streak, and basically they're in the same boat as Ouachita. Ouachita's had a lot of success, but really just in the last few years, so it should be really interesting to see.
Well, it's going to be a fun day around Cliff Harris Stadium today. For our pregame show today, we're going to have a lot for you, as we got to talk with some friends from around the Ouachita community, but also from the Northwest Missouri State football community as well. Got some great input from there too. But it's going to be a great day around here, and we're going to get the pregame festivities underway after this break with an interview with Coach David Sharp to further break down how the D2 playoffs roll out and the whole seeding process. We'll have that interview in just a few moments on the Captain Henderson House pregame show.
Hello, I'm Taylor King. I've been practicing law for over 34 years, but long before that, I learned what it takes to be a good lawyer: caring for others. You could say it's a family trait, and it's one I've passed along to my kids. If you've been involved in an accident, call 1-800-CAR-WRECK. I want to help.
We want to help, to be on your side, by your side. I'm Austin King. Now, I've not been practicing law quite as long as my dad, but thanks to him, I know what it takes to be a good lawyer. I guess you could say it runs in the family.
Our town, A place for new beginnings, stalwart pine trees, reuniting with old friends. Whether you find yourself here for a ball game, a wedding, or just to catch up with those you love, we want to invite you to be a guest on our front porch. A place to sit back and watch the world go by. A place where time seems to slow down. Our home away from home. Welcome back. Captain Henderson House, now accepting reservations.
And welcome back to halftime at Bill Vining Arena. Ouachita leading this one 28-24. But here for just a few moments, we're going to move from basketball to football as we have Ouachita Athletic Director David Sharp here with us. Coach Sharp, thanks for joining us.
Hey, glad to be here. Thanks for having me on.
So this Saturday, it's going to be a fun matchup at Cliff-Harris Stadium. Exciting time as the Ouachita Tigers host the Bearcats of Northwest Missouri State. Coach, for those who aren't as familiar with the Division II selection process, how are the teams selected and how is the seeding go when it comes to the playoffs?
Yeah, you know, it's something that, I've been a part of since 2002 when I got involved in Division II football on the national level, and I served on the national committee, and it's been a few changes, but I know one thing that hasn't changed is four regions. They have four super regions, and basically you got about 40-plus teams in each region, and seven teams make it to the playoffs. They're selected that way. There's certain criteria and rationale that they measure each year. And, Ouachita, we're in there, and, we're in a tough region. You've got national champions in there. You've got defending national champions. You've got a team we're playing this week that's got four or five national championships of perennial power. So it'll be a tough task, but the process is done regionally, and we just happen to be in one of the toughest regions in the country.
You mentioned the Bearcats, really one of the blue bloods of Division II football. It will be a tough matchup, but it's going to be a fun matchup for Ouachita at home.
Yeah, they've got a great program up there. I'm very familiar with them. I watched them win some national championships when I was on the committee. Of course, I've been at every championship game since 2002. And they have a historic head coach. He's retired now, and retired athletic director, a gentleman named Coach Mel Chirchma. And Coach Chirchma will actually be at our game on Saturday watching. He's a good friend of mine, good friend of Coach Knight's, and just a great coach. But the Northwest has had a super program, continue to have a super program. A lot of respect for that institution, a lot of respect for their football team. It should be a good matchup Saturday with the Tigers and the Bearcats.
And Ouachita is a program that's built a lot of tradition in its own right, getting to host a playoff game in the NCAA Division II playoffs for the first time since 2019. What does that mean to the Ouachita Athletics program as a whole to get to host games like that?
I just think it's great, obviously, for Ouachita Athletics, but I think it's a tribute to Coach Knight, his staff, and the team, and where they are with that program, and the culture that they've built down there, and the consistency that they have in having teams that are making the playoffs. You know, we made it in 2019 and, you know, in 18. And so it's great to see. It's you know, when things become the norm, that shows that you're making progress. And so I think it just means so much to the institution. The visibility of Ouachita nationwide is out there, and it's always rewarding when I go to conventions, or if I go across the country, or if I go site rep somewhere. I don't have to explain who Ouachita is. I don't have to say anything. They know who we are, and I think that's a tribute to Coach Knight and his staff and what we've done in the last 20 years.
And you mentioned Coach Knight, an exciting honor announced for him today. The all GAC honors were announced, and Coach Knight named the GAC coach for the year, coach of the year, for the sixth time in the 11-year history of the conference. Yeah. What an accomplishment.
Yeah, congratulations to him. Well deserved. He's very humble about it. He don't want any accolades, but I don't think that'll be the last award he'll get this year in coaching. I wouldn't be surprised to see him getting some, regional coaching recognition and maybe even some national coaching recognition.
And a lot of players getting recognized today, too.
Yeah,
nine different players receiving first-team All-American honors. And you saw a lot of offensive linemen, all of the starting offensive linemen for the Tigers, either making the first or second team All-Conference. Really speaks to the strength of that unit.
Yeah, and both running backs making first or second team. And, you know, of course, it's a tribute to that offensive line and the depth that we have there and the age that we have there. And so it's congratulations to all those guys that made All-Conference.
And for Saturday, a great opportunity for Ouachita students and staff, I've heard, when it comes to the game.
Yeah, you know, it's when you get to the NCAA playoffs, you know, it's a tournament now. And in the NCAA, we're on the hook for some admissions, and you can't give complimentary admissions, but due to a gift, we are able to our students can get in with their ID, and faculty and staff and their dependents can get in with their ID. And we want all the Tigers to, you know, all those folks to come out and support the Tigers. It's going to be a great day for football. You know, it's not going to be 80 degrees. It's going to be about 50, maybe 50, maybe a little bit under 50. It's supposed to be sunny. Should be a little warmer than it was last week for the Battle of the Ravine. Plus, we're starting an hour earlier. You know, I like to start games at 1 o'clock, and so it's going to be a great day. We're going to tailgate down there like we always do for home games. We've got such a great environment down there at Clip Harris Stadium, and man, it's hard to believe we're in our eighth year of games at Clip Harris Stadium, and what we've created down there with not only the students, but with the fans and the tailgating and just everything that goes on. It's a great environment down there.
And now with the free tickets, really no excuse to miss out on the festivities.
No excuse not to be there. And
well, we got to see Chase and Coach Sharp have a great conversation there. And it's always great hearing from Coach Sharp and hearing about the playoff schedule and the playoff breakdown. I know it can be very confusing to talk about, and I know that Coach Sharp was able to clear up a lot of things there.
Well, and Coach Sharp is a veteran as the athletic director for Ouachita. He's had a lot of experience, not only from the administrative side of that, but also from the coaching perspective as well. So he was able to give us some great input. But it really is crazy when you think about it, because it is regionally ranked, and just the concentration of power that we see in the central ranking or in the central region for Division II. You look at a handful of teams there ranked in the top 10. If you look at a lot of the polls, this is considered a top 10 matchup pretty much unanimously. In the AFCA poll, this is number 3 Ouachita taking on number 8 Northwest Missouri State. So two teams who have had excellent campaigns in 2022. Two teams that are going to meet up with each other in the first round. You don't always expect to see that, but that's exactly what we've got here today, and it's going to be a great matchup. Both teams are going to be leaving it all out there on the field today. And we go to another interview now, because you, Chris, got a chance to talk with Nate Olson, who not only has experience with the Bearcats, he's an alum of Northwest Missouri State, but also has some experience covering the Great American Conference as a reporter with Scorebook Live.
Yeah, it was great hearing from Nate. He has a unique perspective. He graduated at Northwest Missouri State, and he still has his loyalties with them, but he's spent a lot of time in Arkansas. Really, his entire professional career has been in Arkansas, covering mostly Arkansas high school sports, but he's also covered a lot of the GAC. But at the same time, he still has a lot of knowledge about both Northwest Missouri State and the MIAA.
Very knowledgeable individual indeed, and we're going to see that interview now. This is Nate Olson of Scorebook Live.
I'm Chris Gay, and I'm joined here by Nate Olson, one of the most prominent voices in Arkansas sports, especially Arkansas high school sports. Interesting thing about him, he is a Bearcat alum, an alum of Northwest Missouri State. Thank you for being here, Nate.
Yeah, I appreciate that introduction. I need to send you a check. That's awfully kind of you to call me prominent. We just cover high school sports as well as we can, and I've been here 25 years. I guess when you've been here a long time, you know, people know who you are. But I'm glad to be in Arkansas and a proud Bearcat alum. Go Bearcat.
Northwest Missouri State, in a big conference, the MIAA, and it's been noted that there's a distinct difference in size of schools between the Great American Conference and MIAA. But here at Ouachita, there's a very strong culture, especially around football. What is the culture like at Northwest Missouri State?
Well, it's really great. And I think when you win, you see that at OBU. You know, you've got the Cliff Harris Stadium, which is one of the premier venues in Division II, and all that stuff comes from winning. You know, when I came to school at Northwest in 93, we played at Rick and Broad Stadium. I mean, a lot of high school fields were better than it. And as they started winning championships, the new Bearcat Stadium was built, renovations were made. It's a very, very nice facility now. And when you win, that also brings, you know, not only fan support, but monetary support. People want to be involved. And the MIAA, you know, is an older league. So you had Pittsburgh State and Kansas. They're really good again this year. They're undefeated. But when I was growing up and coming to school, they were dominating. And so you had them, and then Northwest rose to prominence. But you've also got Missouri Western, which is Northwest's big rival, Central Missouri State, and some others who have had some success. And so that league has really thrived because it's been around for decades, and there's some pretty good rivalries in it and a good fan following. So, I mean, I feel like because of Pittsburgh State, Northwest, and then some other schools that have had some success, it's made it one of the better conferences. But, you know, we do a GAC report. Rex Nelson does it on our scoreboard show, and I chime in. I follow the GAC with the show, and we talk about it, and I admire, you know, the league, and I think it's a lot better than people give it credit for. And I think OBU is real, you know, they've risen to the top there. And Coach Todd Knight, what he does a great job of is getting a lot of these Arkansas kids that are maybe borderline Division I type kids and gets them to come to OBU. And he does that with the culture they have there, with the fan following, with the facilities. So, you know, I think the GAC, you know, maybe a notch or two below the MIAA, but a lot of it is just because it's so new. But I think with successful programs like OBU, Harding, Henderson State, the Arkansas teams, I think, have a lot of tradition and success of playing each other. So I think it's a great league, and I love to follow it. And I've been to almost every venue. I think every venue in Arkansas. My nephew played at UAM several years ago, and I enjoyed touring, going to all those places.
Well, for those of our audience that doesn't know much about Northwest Missouri State, out of Maryville, Missouri, and I did a little bit of research, and there's some traditions with Northwest Missouri State. Obviously, homecoming is big on campus when it comes to football. But there's one thing that I just want to make sure, if you know anything about this, one of the traditions that I'd seen online was the tradition of throwing the goalpost into Colden Pond. Yeah. What do you know about that?
Well, so I think when that tradition was born, the second year of Mel Churchma, so that would have been in 95, I think it was. So they went 0-11, and then the next year they went 5-6 his second year, and they snapped the losing streak against Southwest Baptist, and they took the post and brought it in there, and all got in there, the team did. And so it's kind of been a tradition. And we had this columnist at the newspaper that nobody ever knew who it was. It's supposed to be anonymous. And the person that was chosen was always a little snarky, you know, that kind of thing. And that column that week when those guys went in that pond was, you know, they may never be able to have kids again because who knows what's in that pond. You know, in college I was pretty daring, and I don't know if I would have gotten in there. But, yeah, so that pond sits right next to the stadium. And so, I mean, I don't know that they brought the posts in that time, but they got in it. And so maybe after that, the students have done that with the, you know, winning the playoff games. I think they've done it a couple times. Man, you know, a couple times too, it's snowed there during playoff semifinals. And that pond, yeah, it'd be really cold. But it's really cool. That's a great tradition with it being right there. The campus is very beautiful. And, you know, now it's colder. So, but a couple weeks ago, you know, the foliage and everything there, it's quite beautiful there.
Well, and you mentioned that anonymous columnist, and I believe it's called The Stroller, if I'm correct.
Yeah, yeah.
I just think that's interesting.
I had kind of forgotten that name. I'm glad you brought it back to me. Yeah. And whoever, you know, we weren't supposed to know who did it, and I think everybody kind of tried to figure it out, and I figured it out a couple different times. But The only person that was supposed to know was the managing editor. But I was on staff for 3 years, and I was pretty close to, I think, getting it, pretty much figuring it out. But that was a great line. There were some great lines in that column, but that was a really good one, saying that they'd be sterile, not have children, because they got in that water.
Yeah, that's great. So on to football. Northwest Missouri State, highly successful. Now, older football program, football conference, but almost 60% winning percentage all time in the regular season.
Yep.
Almost about 63% in winning percentage in the conference. And then, of course, 32 conference championships, four consecutive right now, and then 26 playoff appearances in the Division II, 18 consecutive. Yeah. So this is another animal that Ouachita is going to face, something they haven't quite seen yet.
Yeah, it's a tough draw for you guys, I think. And I'm saying this is not just a Northwest alum, but somebody that follows college football and follows the GAC, you know, with Rex on Friday night. I mean, they're 9-2, but they play in a really tough league, and I've probably seen a little more competition than OBU has. And I think whenever you are playing, you know, a team like that, it's tough because they expect to win. They expect to win. They expect to come down here and win the ball game. And that tradition came from Mel Churchma, who took over my sophomore year of college and turned them into a juggernaut, and then handed it off to Adam Dorrell, who was one of my classmates that played on the national championship team on the offensive line. Now Rich Wright has taken over. And Rich has been a part of the Bearcat program as an assistant. And so it's all just trickled down, and that's made that program to where, you know, there's high expectations. And when they recruit kids, they're recruiting kids that are championship caliber kids. They expect to win the championship in the conference. They expect to go deep in the playoffs. And I think when you have that attitude, you're really hard to beat. And so I think that's going to be a tough task for OBU. I think being at home is a big help for them. And, you know, I think we get a little disrespect. Both schools do, having to play at Grand Valley if they win. So if I was Coach Todd Knight, I'd be drumming that a little bit about, you know, the kind of disrespect and a little bit of a chip on their shoulder. But I think it'll be a good game. But yeah, you're right about the tradition. I mean, there's really nobody else that has that right now in Division II. And if you'd have told me that when I was a freshman in college there, I wouldn't have believed it, because it was so bad. And I remember a lot of kids wouldn't go to the games, but I went to every one of the games, even the 0-11 year, went to almost all those games, and because I just like being there. But it's a remarkable, remarkable turnaround to where they are now.
Well, and the tradition for the Bearcats is so rich, but so is it for Ouachita, six conference championships and five playoff appearances. So not nearly as many as the six-time national champ, the Bearcats, but the success has really come of late. And, you know, in addition to the great culture here at Ouachita, you have the Battle of the Ravine, which for those that are familiar with Arkansas sports sure know about Battle of the Ravine. So have you ever had a chance to be here for Battle of the Ravine?
I did. I went, I think it was in 2019, the fall of 2019, I believe, is when I went, and they won. It was at Cliff Harris Stadium. It's remarkable. I mean, it is a cool, I don't think it's just the best Division II rivalry. I think it's one of the best in college football. And I think that if anybody came here just, you know, as a neutral fan, they would be impressed no matter where in the country they watch football. And my friend, Colin McDonough, he is the SID at Northwest. I told him, I said, when you're coming up the road, look in both directions. And when you're in the press box, look across the street at Henderson. You know, you can see the game going on over there from the press box if there's two games going on at the same time. And Rex likes to, you know, sometimes if there's staggered starts, like do the Ouachita game, then run over to Henderson and watch the end of that one. It's a cool deal. I mean, and as a sports fan, as a college football fan, I'll never forget it. It came up on my timeline today or yesterday on Facebook when I went, and to see the Reddies walking across the street, it's just, there's nothing like that. It's really awesome. And I think, I think you do have a great culture there, and I really respect Todd Knight. I've talked to him numerous times throughout my career. I think what he does a great job of doing is taking the kids that, you know, are borderline Division One, and then, you know, like bringing them to Ouachita, and they have a lot of talent. I mean, that's it's cool to see kids that you saw in high school then playing at OBU. So he's done an awesome job, and I think he's risen them to, you know, one of the premier programs in Division Two. And now you guys just need to win a playoff game and make a little bit of a run. And if you do that, that's what Northwest did. You know, you got in the playoffs, won a game, then they won championships. If OBU can do that, they're going to have a national reputation.
Thank you, Chris, for that great interview. It's always great to have people like Nate Olson around to really kind of bridge the gap between the Great American Conference as well as the MIAA. You know, not a lot of people have experience in both areas, but he's one of those rare individuals who does, and he really does give our fan base here a better feel for what Northwest Missouri football, Missouri State football, is all about.
Yeah, and one of the things I wanted to talk with him about was, we know here at Ouachita we have such a rich tradition, and it's, you know, especially behind like Battle of the Ravine, but we don't know much about Northwestern Missouri State. I mean, this is the first time we've ever seen them before in a game. So getting to hear about the culture of the Bearcats was really great to see. Well, now we get to hear from OSDN's Isaac Bourne, who got to talk about the X's and O's of Northwest Missouri State football with Matt Daniel of the Bleeding Green podcast, who covers all Northwest Missouri State football. So we'll be back right after this break for more of the Captain Henderson House pregame show.
All right, welcome back to I'm here with Matt Daniels here, and from the Bleeding Green podcast. And today, would you explain kind of like what your podcast is about for any Northwest Missouri State fans watching right now?
Yeah, sure. I appreciate it, and I appreciate you guys having me on. So if you search Bleeding Green, just Bleeding Green on Spotify or wherever you can download podcasts, it should come up. I also have a website, bleedinggreenpodcast.com, that folks can go check that out. It shows you all the different places. And I'm just a fan. You know, I have a background in broadcasting. I used to work in radio. Now I'm just a dad of three with a kind of a crazy normal life. I work from home, so that allows me some flexibility to be able to do this, but it's really kind of from a fan's perspective. So I had Rex Nelson on this week. We always get somebody from the opposing team, and then we always have a player interview. I have something I like to call the pick six, just kind of six goofy questions at the end. And so we'll talk to players, local media, media from the other team. And then I have my 11-year-old son, Eli, has a segment where we do predictions and things, and he gives me a hard time. So it's a lot of fun. It's definitely a project of passion for sure. But I love it, and that's why I do it. And I certainly appreciate you guys having me on.
Yes, sir. I totally get that. So, let's kind of get into the game this weekend and talk about, you know, what you expect from both sides of the game.
Well, sure. I mean, I think this is a good game. You've kind of got the running game of the Tigers versus the tough defense of the Bearcats. I think that's probably what everybody would say is the identity of the two teams. That's definitely the identity of this Bearcat team. And a Rich Wright coach team will always have that identity. We're always going to be a strong defensive team. He also coaches the defensive line. That's a position he coaches. He's shares defensive coordinator duties. And so, you know, the Bearcats are just kind of a tough, hard-nosed team. And this isn't, you know, obviously we have the tradition in the playoffs and everything. This isn't your traditionally, strong Bearcat offensive team. They've been really clutch at times, but this team's just really gritty and tough. They've had to win different ways all season long. They had a couple early losses, and it's been kind of 5 weeks in a row of basically playoff football, and they've known that. But if you go back to the Washburn win, I mean, that was the defense gives up a touchdown with 30 some seconds left, and the offense has to make a couple of plays, gets in field goal range. And our kicker, Cole Lammel, had a really rough season last year. He's had a great year. He was third team all conference this year when that came out earlier this week. And it's been a great year for him. He kicks the game winning field goal in that game. You go to last week where we played one of the top offensive teams in the country in Emporia State. And it was kind of the opposite of that. It was the defense that really had to make some plays down the line. And I tweeted out a stat earlier this week Emporia had five possessions at midfield or in Bearcat territory. They didn't score on any of them. And so including the last two drives of the game, a turnover on downs and an interception by the first team all-conference Khalil Smith, our corner, who had just given up a big play earlier in the fourth quarter. So that was kind of great for him. But as far as what the Bearcats want to do, the Bearcats, kind of like the Tigers, they want to run the football. We can throw the football. Quarterback is going to be Mikey Hohensee is going to probably start the game. Braden Wright, who's a senior, is going to come in and play. And they have a little bit different skill sets, but they're both athletic. They can both run. Both have had 300-yard passing games this season. Mikey's had two of them, and Braden's had one. But the guy is kind of the bell cow for this Bearcat offense is number 22. He's a true freshman, Jay Harris. And he's kind of they burned his red shirt a few games into the season, and he just kind of every week he gets a little bit more and more carries. He's just a really big physical back. I can't overstate the fact that he's a true freshman. That just doesn't happen at Northwest. Here for the last 25 to 30 years, we've kind of had a tradition of guys come in, we redshirt them. And then, you know, maybe they see the field a little bit as a redshirt freshman or a sophomore and then, you know, kind of start later. He came in, they took his redshirt off. He does not play like an 18-year-old kid. He plays like a much older man. He's a big physical back. Jamar Moya leads the team in receptions and rushing. He's a really good, he was a first team all conference, kind of all purpose back. And so, but I mean, don't get me wrong. The strength of this team is definitely the defense and the front seven. The back four has kind of been burned at different times, although they really stepped up, probably played their best game last week.
Yeah, that's what I've seen when I look at this team. The Bearcat defense, specifically that front line, is just very powerful. You've got Elijah Green, Zach Howard, those two guys alone averaging, 20 sacks on the season, or have 20 sacks on the season?
Yeah, and Zach is a guy. It's funny because Zach is an All-American last year. He's kind of the guy that gets all of the attention, and you know, he's got the size. You look at him, okay, you know, he's a big guy. You look at Elijah, he's a guy that's 5'11". He came in as a linebacker. He's a Maryville kid. Great story, and he's a spectacular young man, as so many are on this team. But he is kind of really – he worked on his pass rushing a lot in the offseason. He led the MIAA in sacks and tackles for loss. In fact, he was the conference defensive player of the year. Both him and Zach are first team. And another guy to watch is number 95. He's a defensive end, Jake Fisher. He's a young guy, and he has a few sacks this season, but there are times when he is just absolutely destroyed at the tackle going against them. So he's kind of a fun guy to watch. But there's a lot of guys that rotate in. Again, that's kind of Coach Wright's baby, is that D-line. And, you know, that's the strength. They really free up the linebackers to fly around. All three are really great. Isaac Volstead in the middle is a guy that covers a tremendous amount of ground with his speed. And Sam Phillips, another guy who's you know, an all-conference type of player and been a great linebacker. His brother was an all-conference defensive player of the year several years ago at Northwest. And Andrew Dumas is a guy who's kind of made that other linebacker spot his, and he's had a great game last week. Again, all you know, the D-line takes up space and lets those linebackers fly around and do what they do.
Yes. So I know you guys experienced the selection show this past week, and, you know, going in, you didn't know if you were going to fully get in. So, you know, what was that feeling of continuing that 18th consecutive playoff appearance this year? And, you know, how did it feel to know you guys got in?
Well, it was really great. You know, I had a feeling, and a lot of us were watching your guys' game on Saturday, really rooting for you because we knew if Henderson State won, they probably get that last playoff spot. And so, you know, the Bearcats have been kind of lower. They needed some things to happen. And I think everyone was kind of satisfied with they gave it their all, got the big win in Emporia. But it was still – I was about 60% sure on Saturday. By the time Sunday rolled around, I think I was maybe 75% sure that we were going to get in, but I wasn't sure, and I wasn't sure where we were going to play. And, you know, so yeah, I mean, it's great. Listen, we're incredibly spoiled as Bearcat fans. I'm approaching 40, and the last time we missed the playoffs was 2003 when I was a sophomore in Northwest. So we're incredibly spoiled, but you know, we're just so happy, you know, road, home, it doesn't matter. We get to and hey, I was kind of excited because I've never been to Arkadelphia before, never been to see a game, and with you guys. And plus, traveling south this time of year is always kind of nice. So,
well, an interesting stat that I thought was funny is Northwest Missouri State has never missed the playoffs since I've been alive. Since I was born in 2004, every single year I've been alive, Northwest Missouri State has made the playoffs. So I just find that as just such an interesting story and just really cool that you guys have been able to make the playoffs like so often. And, you know, coming from Ouachita's perspective, this is only our fifth time in the past 8 years making the playoffs. But I still feel like, you know, we still have a very formidable team this year. And kind of go into that, talk about, you know, what do you see from this Ouachita team that may give Northwest Missouri State a little bit of a run for their money?
Sure. No, I think this is going to be a great game. I think, and I said on my podcast this week, this is a good matchup for Northwest in the fact that your guys' strength is our strength. You know, running the football, we defend the run. But I don't think that makes Northwest necessarily even the favorite or a guarantee to win this game or you know, walk all over. You know, obviously, if we're going to talk about Ouachita Baptist, you know, it's TJ Cole. I mean, he's the guy that everybody talks about. And I'll be honest, I've kind of watched you guys pretty closely this year. I played in the D2Football.com fantasy football league this year, and TJ was my first round pick. And so he carried me to a third place finish. So that was great. So I was always checking your guys' box scores. I mean, we know about Kendall Givens and what he can do, almost ran for 1,000 yards himself. And Riley Harms, the quarterback, you know, a guy from who played in the MIAA for a while, was behind TJ Davis at Nebraska Kearney. So we definitely know about him. And that was the thing that kind of struck me last week was how well, you know, Ouachita ran the 2-minute drill, and especially to get back in that game and come late. You know, I kind of was like, wow, you know, because I think the Tigers are going to have to throw the football to move the ball against the Bearcats. Not that I'm saying won't necessarily be able to run the football, but it's going to be tough, certainly. But to me, the big match, and that's fun, right? That's fun in the playoffs. You get, you know, strength on strength. That's the way that it's supposed to be. I think this will be, you know, both teams want to run the football. But the thing that I look at is the Bearcat offense against the Tiger defense, because the ability of Ouachita to force turnovers, and turnovers have been a weak point of the Bearcats. Now, the Bearcats did force three last week, although we had two ourselves. And so, you know, kind of throughout the year, we've always been on the negative side of that. I think that's the big key to this game, to me, is the turnover battle. Is, you know, if the Bearcats or whichever team is on the negative side of turnovers is probably the team that loses the game. I think it's very thin margins, of course, when you're in the playoffs. And so although, you know, yes, you know, I think Bearcat fans in general, I'm a fan, you know, that's my perspective. I think Bearcat fans in general are like this matchup, but I don't think anybody thinks this is going to be a walk in the park or anything like that. We have a ton of respect. I personally have a ton of respect for Ouachita Baptist, and I'm just really excited to see, I think what's going to be a great game on Saturday.
Yes, sir. I totally get that. So you were talking about TJ Cole being, you know, such an electric running back, but at the same time, you guys also have Jamar Moya and his all-purpose capabilities. So what do you see from him? What do you expect to see from him this weekend, especially since, you know, he's got so many rushing yards, but also a bunch of – he's third on the team in receiving yards this season as well. So, you know, Jamar Moya is a kind of a jack-of-all-trades for you guys.
Yeah, I think he's got like 23 more receptions than the number two guy on the team. He is. I think we didn't see as much of him last week. I don't really know whether it was an injury or what it was, but he definitely brings something different. He's a little guy, so looking at him, you know, if you haven't seen the Bearcats play and you know, you're kind of looking at him, he's a little guy. I think maybe he's 180 pounds, but he also is a tough runner between the tackles. He will punish guys just as much as he gets punished. He can really run over people. He's kind of dynamic in space but the last, you know, 2-4 weeks, I mean, Jay Harris is the true freshman that I mentioned earlier, has really gotten more. He's a guy that I kind of joke, on game day, he just kind of falls forward for a yard. So if it's third and a yard, fourth and inches, something like that, most likely you're going to see number 22 back there carrying the football. But we have other good backs too. A really cool story is Robert Rawi. He was a guy that kind of started to get, you know, at least half of the carries early in the season, had a really bad shoulder injury. We thought his career was over with. He came and he had a carry last week. He was dressed out. So that's a cool story. I don't know how much he'll figure in, but I had to mention him, give him some love. Jaden Brady's a guy who is a good kick returner for the Cats. He's had, I think, the longest rush by a non-quarterback this season of 52 yards a couple of weeks ago that kind of broke the Missouri Southern game open early in the second half. And he's a guy, he's a great receiver out of the backfield. He won't see that in the box score very much, but he can definitely catch the ball. And really, all these running backs are, you know, there's several you might see. Tank Young's the guy we've seen get carries throughout the year. And so a really dynamic player you watch out for, who's gotten a lot of attention. He hasn't really, flown off the stat sheet the last few weeks is Kashawn Griffin. He's a junior college transfer, which, again, you know, Northwest is just one of those teams where, you know, to see junior college guys come in or true freshmen play, you just don't always see that a lot. And so, you know, those guys have to be pretty good. And so KG, as they call him, Kashawn Griffin, he's electric. There's a portion of the season he was leading the nation in punt return yardage. He's a guy who has blazing speed, and they probably want to get the ball to him in space, I think, and he can really make some special things happen.
Yes, sir. I definitely see on both sides of the ball two teams that match up just really well against each other. It's going to be a fun matchup this Saturday. I'm excited to be at the game, and hopefully we'll see you there, right?
Yep, I will definitely be there. I'm bringing the family, and so we'll be up in the stands rooting for our Bearcats. But yeah, if anybody, Ouachita fans, whoever, Bearcat fans, want to come say hi, definitely we'd get a thrill out of that.
Yes, sir. Well, thank you for being on today, and thank you guys for watching OSDN, and please stay tuned.
Thank you, Isaac, for that interview. Matt had some great insight on Northwest Missouri State football. And we're gonna provide a little bit more insight into today's matchup now, Chris, as this is one that everyone's been looking forward to. You saw that lineup, or that matchup really, when it was first announced for the lineup of the D2 playoffs, and you saw that and you were like, okay, these are two of the, really the top two teams in the classification facing off against each other. Really, the crowd's gonna get their money's worth in the first round here.
Yeah, and these are two teams that are actually pretty similar in the way they play. Both teams are very strong running teams, and then every once in a while they'll step back and try to pass it, and they're pretty efficient, you know, in the passing game. But one thing worth noting is that Ouachita has the unanimous first team all GAC selection in TJ Cole, and over 1,600 rushing yards, and that is definitely a lot more than any running back for the Bearcats. But the Bearcats have multiple rushers that are well over 200 yards, so it should be really interesting to see who can have the most success in the run game.
And also Kendall Givens right there in the second team all GAC. You don't see that too often, where you see two different running backs in the top two teams in the conference, but that's exactly what happened for the Tigers this year. 9 selections for the first team all GAC, and when you look at those first two units, the entire starting lineup for the offensive line for Ouachita is either first team or second team all GAC. Really a talented group, but they're going to have their work cut out for them this week against a staunch defensive line for the Bearcats, and that's going to be headed up by the MIAA Defensive Player of the Year, Elijah Green.
I mean, you're not kidding. That guy's a beast. 11.5 sacks, 21 tackles for a loss. This is a run defense that's only allowed 600 rushing, or just a little bit over 600 rushing yards on the season, versus they've had almost 2,000 rushing yards on the season as a team. So I imagine the game plan will not be any different. Ouachita is still kind of try to run them out and try to tire out that defense. And then if that doesn't work, then they're going to use Riley Harms, and they're going to see what they can do with guys like Connor Flanagan, Justin Dean.
Yes, and really another interesting thing to note with Green and his accomplishment is that we've talked about the somewhat of a dynasty that you see there at Northwest Missouri State just all around. But how about the defensive line dynasty? 3 straight years in a row where the defensive player of the year for the MIAA has come from the defensive line position at Northwest Missouri State. It's rare when you see that back-to-back. It's extremely rare when you see it 3 times in a row. There's a lot of talent at that position for the Bearcats.
Yeah, and they've won that award about a dozen times since like the late 90s, and that again is very unusual to see. You don't even see that with a lot of Division I programs, let alone Division II, but it's a testament to how successful they have been on defense. It doesn't matter the defensive line, just overall that defense has been great. And not only, you know, is their line great, they have 2 linebackers that are also all conference second team, and then they have a member of their secondary that is all-conference honorable mention. So they're a very deep defense. They have a lot of ball players in all three levels of that defense, and it's going to give Ouachita some headaches. But like we said, they got some players too on offense.
And you touched on that just a little bit. We've talked about the defense for Northwest Missouri State. Let's talk about the defense for Ouachita. Who are going to be some of the standout guys in this one, and what's really going to be the key to success defensively for the Tigers?
Well, guys like Jax Miller, Dawson Miller, are going to be great in that linebacker core, Ty Compton. Of course, this is a team, they do like to pass. They don't pass, you know, that much, but about the same amount as Ouachita. And guys like Anthony Freeman and even guys like Chance Taylor, they're going to have, their chances to add on some sacks. And it's going to be really interesting to see what the defensive line can do as far as applying pressure, which they've done pretty well at all season long.
And at this point in the year, you really have to throw records out the window because everybody's good at this point. But this is one of the more balanced matchups you're going to see across D2 all year long. It's going to be a great atmosphere today at Cliff-Harris Stadium. We're glad to have a great crowd out here today, as well as at home watching with us today. And in just a few moments, we're going to have the opening kickoff of the ball game. And thank you to all of our reporters and for my colleague Chris. This is Chase Hartzell signing off for the Captain Henderson House pregame show. Ouachita football is on its way in just a few moments.
I'm Nicole Auerbach from The Athletic.
Hey, this is Alex Pruitt with Sports Illustrated Magazine.
This is Kevin Kugler of Westwood One.
Hi, everybody. It's Pete Kranick of the Memphis Grizzlies and Fox Sports Southeast.
This is Danielle Musselman.
This is Kyle Peterson with ESPN.
This is Tom Hart of ESPN and the SEC Network. Thanks for tuning in to the Ouachita Sports Digital Network.
Beautiful day for playoff football here in Arkadelphia at Cliff-Harris Stadium on the campus of Ouachita Baptist University. This is Jeff Root. I don't sound quite like myself, but Richard is here, and he does sound like Richard Atkinson. So, Richard, very important break already for the Ouachita Tigers. They're going to get the ball first.
Yeah, and really the matchup to watch today is the Ouachita run game against this Northwestern defense. Ouachita comes in the game the number 4 rushing offense in the country. Northwestern the number 2 rushing defense in the country. So, it's really a great, great Northwestern defense as usual. A very, very good Ouachita offense as they're number 7 in the country, or number 2 in the country in scoring. So that's going to be the matchup to watch, and we're going to see it from the very beginning. As Ouachita did elect to receive, they're going to send Zaylen Falls and Justin Dean back and try and get out and get on the scoreboard first.
Tigers looking forward to this kickoff return, and we are too. Let's go to the voice of the Ouachita Tigers, Rex Nelson.
Thank you, Dr. Jeff Root. Playoff football at Cliff Harris Stadium. Zaylin Falls, Justin Dean, as Richard said, the deep men for the Tigers. Purple jerseys, white numerals, black pants today for Ouachita. Here is the kick. And Dean's going to have a return. He takes it at the 8, up over the 10, up over the 15. Got a bit of a seam. Nice return out over the 25 to about the 28-yard line. And, Richard, you nailed it. Ouachita's third in the nation in rushing. Northwest Missouri, second in the nation in rush defense. Strength against strength.
Yeah, and second in the nation is not giving up 100 yards a game or anything like that. It's giving up 56 yards a game. Ouachita runs for over 300. They're not going to shy away from the run. But it's going to be very interesting to see how they hold up against that front seven. But Ouachita is going to have to mix in the pass some today.
Oh, yeah. I think they'll mix in a lot of short passes today with an occasional deep shot. I think this game may ride on Riley Harms, how good a game he has. First down and 10. They come out of the pistol. They'll go immediately to the All-American T.J. Cole, and he'll lose a yard, Richard, and that's just what we're talking about. Great job by Northwestern King on Cole and on the tackle for Northwest. Well, Ouachita comes no huddle, so we'll go right back to play. Out into the flats, Connor Flanagan has got it out over the 25. They're going to mark him at the 29. Still, though, it's going to be third and long, Jeff. Third and 8 facing the Tigers.
They're going to have to go a little farther downfield. That was a quick pass and a quick play, but it was well defended and it got short yardage.
So Tigers are going to have to complete a pass if they want to keep from going three and out. Two men split to either side as they move right to left early in this third quarter. They send Justin Dean in motion left to right. Harms sets up. Has some time. Now he's forced out of the pocket. Throws on the run, and it's not near anybody. Three and out for Ouachita.
Well, Ouachita wanted to go to Connor Flanagan. He's lobbing the official, say, what happened? His jersey was ripped off of him. His whole shoulder pads are hanging out and went to the ground. He had one-on-one coverage. That's what they wanted, and I think the officials are going to say they must have gotten him within the first couple yards where you can have contact. But the protection held up there, Rex, for Riley Harms. There was just nothing down the field as he tried to throw on the run. A cold day, the grip on the football just not quite there, and Ouachita goes three and out.
So fourth and 8, and Joe Couch out of Australia, one of the best punters in the country, will be called on to get off a good one here early as the sun begins to peek out at Cliff Harris Stadium. We'll take a bounce, and Ouachita will cover it down at the 34. So here will come Northwest Missouri. As I said on the pregame show, Jeff, truly they are Division II royalty. They're to Division II, with the University of Alabama as to Division I. More national championships than anybody, more playoff appearances than anybody in the country.
It is absolutely true, and they've done it more with defense than offense this year, but obviously they have a strong record and a good offense, and we'll see if Ouachita can stop them early.
Mike Owensee, the quarterback, he is going to give on the ground on first down. Coming left and finding very little is Jamar Moya. Good job by Ouachita.
Well, they tried to attack the outside that time. Ouachita had a little bit of trouble last week against Henderson on the outside run. That time for Ouachita, Ty Compton said no way. And so both teams run the ball on first down and go for negative yards. These are two good defenses playing today.
And so second down and 12 following the two-yard loss. On second and 12. Here is the give to Moya again. He's up over the 35, up over the 40, near a first down, needing to get to the 45-yard line. He's going to have it. They're going to move the chains. So very quickly, Richard, after losing yardage on first down, Moya comes back and gets a new set of downs for the Bearcats.
Well, Compton made the tackle on the last time. This time tried to dip inside of the block, and that really gave up the outside. It gave up contain trying to dip inside that block, and that's what opened it up there.
First down and 10, ball at the 45-yard line as they move left to right. Owensee, straight drop back, got a man in the right flats, out to midfield, makes it down to the Ouachita 48-yard line, bringing in the ball for Northwest, Jaden Brady. So Brady brings them past midfield as the sun now does come out, and they've quickly moved into Ouachita territory to the Ouachita 47. That's a gain of another 8, so it is second down and 2 for the Bearcats of Northwest Missouri. Owensee out of the shotgun this time, sends a wide out to his left. They set on the near hash mark, moving left to right. Hoensie, quarterback draw, first down, much more, inside the 40 to the Ouachita 38-yard line. Very good play call that time, and Mike Hoensie made it work, Jeff.
Hoensie is known for the pass more than the run, and we do see a flag down on the play right at the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, I think that's going to come back. But I was going to say what we're seeing, Rex, how many times have we seen so far this year a team comes out and scores on the first drive against Ouachita?
Yeah.
And Northwestern Missouri was moving it there, but they're going to call an illegal chop block, so it's going to be a 15-yard penalty. That's a big one.
Yep, Northwest hurts themselves with that penalty as the ball will go all the way back to the Bearcat 38-yard line. So second down and long now for Northwest, and Hoensie will be going upstairs from his 38. No score, 11:55 left in the first quarter. First round NCAA playoffs on second down and long out of the shotgun with one running back set to his left. They're going to give on the ground, surprisingly, and Ouachita's all over it. No gain whatsoever. Great job that time by the Tigers. They had that one read out all the way, Richard. Jax Miller leading the way.
Well, they had some misdirection in the backfield, but Jax Miller saw it. And, of course, a moment ago, it was second and 11, and Northwestern Missouri ran for it and got the first downs. They were trying to catch Ouachita expecting the pass and ran right in the teeth of that defense. Good job by Jax Miller. Now passing situation on third and long.
Third down and 8 from the 37-yard line. Trips to the left side, two men to the right side. So an empty backfield on third and long for Hoensie. Straight drop back, under pressure. Forced to scramble, throws on the run, got a receiver, but he's going to be short of the first down. Going to be short of the first down. Bringing it in for the Bearcats was Travon Alexander, a junior out of Richmond, Missouri. But they're going to have to punt the football, Jeff, at the 49 of Ouachita as they're 4 yards short.
That shot block really cost them, and it's a costly penalty at 15 yards, but it's a dangerous play, so it deserves a 15-yard penalty, and they could not overcome it.
And so Ouachita will get it back after going 3 and out on its first possession of the afternoon. Here is the punt. Hoensie's also the punter. Fair catch called for at the 15-yard line. Connor Flanagan, the fair catch, so the Tigers will be a long way away, 85 yards from the promised land, and we'll see if this offense, Richard, can get anything going this time around.
Well, Northwestern Missouri playing field position there, as you can tell. They do have, well, as you said, the quarterback is the punter, so keep an eye on shenanigans at some point, but they're going to play a field position game, and I don't blame them with the defense they have.
They come out of the pistol now. T.J. Cole set behind his quarterback, Riley Harms. Give to the All-American Cole. Nothing doing right there on the tackle for Northwest was Walker Graves, big junior defensive lineman, and the going on the ground as we thought it might be, Jeff, has been tough so far.
Yeah, no hole at all for Cole. He was hit by a big defensive lineman and had no opportunity to press forward. He normally falls forward, can get yardage after contact. No opportunity that time.
Harms is going to have to loosen him up through the air today. Cole set to the left of Riley Harms. He is passing. In trouble. Going to run it now, and he's got positive yardage. Short of the first down, he does get out to the 19. And going to bring up another passing situation, Richard, 3rd and 6 from the 19.
Yeah, they were trying to get T.J. Cole out of the backfield, and there's some contact down the field he wasn't happy about, but it's the playoffs. They're going to let it play, and that wasn't there. And wisely, Harms tucks it down and gets what he can get. Big third down here. I expect them to be looking for Connor Flanagan. He wasn't able to get free. Ended up on the ground on the last time. We'll see if he can get open here on third down.
Empty backfield with trips to the right. Two men to the near side. Setting up. Harms in trouble again. Gets away but does not have the first down. The ball came out. Did they whistle it dead? I think so. It's recovered by Northwest Missouri and taken into the end zone. Let's wait on the call.
I think he's clearly down. I think they called touchdown, but
yep,
we'll watch the replay.
Yep, they gave it a touchdown for Northwest Missouri.
He was down. His backside was down, and then he was hit up top. It was
bang, bang play,
but they're going to call it a fumble and let it go, and that one hurts.
Wow, hurts big time as the Bearcat defense gets the first points of the afternoon. Here comes the extra point kick that would make it an early 7-0 lead. It is up, and it is good. 8:55 left to go. First quarter, Northwest Missouri 7, Ouachita nothing. Ouachita football 2022, presented by Visit Hot Springs, continues from Cliff Harris Stadium in Arkadelphia in 30 seconds here on the Ouachita Football Network.
Hello, I'm Taylor King. I've been practicing law for over 34 years, but long before that, I learned what it takes to be a good lawyer. Caring for others. You could say it's a family trait, and it's one I've passed along to my kids. If you've been involved in an accident, call 1-800-CAR-WRECK. I want to help.
We want to help, to be on your side, by your side. I'm Austin King. Now, I've not been practicing law quite as long as my dad, but thanks to him, I know what it takes to be a good lawyer. I guess you could say it runs in the family.
For a touchdown, Harms running to his right was not able to hang on to the football as he was hit very hard as he was going down. The call was that he was not down. Ball picked up and run in for a touchdown. So that Ouachita offense not only has not been able to run, not been able to make a first down, now a turnover turns into a touchdown for Northwest.
Wow. So Ouachita finds itself down 7-0 early. Offense will come right back out, of course, after the kickoff. We'll see if they can get anything going this time around. Here is the kick. It's going to be taken at the 14. Good return by Justin Dean this time out to the 30, up to the 31-yard line. First down in 10, Ouachita. And that's one of those things that now they're saying, well, we got flags down.
Yeah,
Richard.
There was a Northwest Missouri player that threw a shoe into the Ouachita bench and just launched it into the bench.
Holy
and I think
cow.
That's probably going to be the – I think that's what the penalty is going to be. I don't know. That I saw the shoe be thrown, and the flag was thrown after that.
Yeah, it was Justin Dean's shoe. They found it and got it back to him.
Last time I saw a shoe-throwing incident, George W. Bush was busted. Remember when the guy threw the shoe at him over in the Middle East?
Yeah.
During a news conference?
15-yarder for that one, too.
Wow.
Reminiscent, I guess,
a few years
ago. Hope
the Secret Service caught 15 yards when they threw it at Bush. Well, that's a break for Ouachita, Richard. Kind of a disciplinary breakdown for the Bearcats.
Pretty easy call by the officials there, too.
So dead ball foul, add 15 to the return, and Ouachita will set up only 54 yards from the promised land. First down and 10 at its 46-yard line. Two wide receivers to either side. Riley Harms, as I was saying, is just going to have to shake that fumble off and get back to work and make something happen. Out into the flats. Got a receiver. Gets up to the 50-yard line and a late hit again. Kendall Gibbons.
Gibbons was about a yard out of bounds and was hit out of bounds. And so 15 more yards for Ouachita. We don't see Ouachita throw it to the running backs very much, especially when lined up at receiver. So this is a new wrinkle, and they're obviously doing that because they want to get the ball to their playmakers, not having to run into the teeth of that Northwest defense. And that time it worked for yards and then add the personal foul on top of it.
So after the play, another personal foul. Ouachita has picked up already 30 yards on this drive, Jeff, on two personal fouls against Northwest Missouri.
First trip into Northwest territory, and the Ouachita fans have enthusiasm. Now, it's a good crowd that's turned out on a cold day.
First down and 10, 37. Clouds have mostly cleared off now. Sun's out. First down and 10, temperature in the low 40s. Here is the give to Kendall Gibbons. The sophomore from Little Rock Christian goes inside the 35 to the 34, where it'll be second down and 7 from the 34.
And I like Ouachita throwing on first down a minute ago. You can't come out and run on first and second down every time and expect to be able to throw against the defense that has 38 sacks on the year. So you got to put you in plus situations. Now, second down here, after they got a good run on first down, 3 or 4 yards, they're going to go direct snap, bring T.J. Cole in. Keep in mind, he can pass the football.
Second down and 7, ball at the 34-yard line. Cole takes the direct snap. He's going to run it. He's met immediately at the line of scrimmage. Got a yard or so, but again, you see why Northwest ranks second in the country against the rush, as Shane Fredrickson, a redshirt freshman out of Lee's Summit, Missouri, was on the tackle.
And he's the safety. You can tell they're playing up close, yep, expecting the run. So they're going to have to do some things to keep the safety out of there. You can't have a safety making play at the line of scrimmage like that. You got to make him worried about the pass down the field.
Well, it's a passing play here. Third down and 7 from the 34. Trips to the right side. Harm sets up. Forced out of the pocket yet again on the roll. And he's just going to have to throw it away. Now, if you try a field goal from here, it is 51, which is in Gabe Goodman's range, Jeff.
Well, we know that. The 53-yarder to beat Henderson last year.
And a 55-yarder earlier this year.
That's right. He has nursed an injury, but he has not missed a field goal this year. He's 7-for-7.
I think Ouachita's going to go for it. I think they were thinking four-down territory from the beginning.
Yeah, they're acting like they're going for it, and they are. So, big play here early with the Tigers trailing 7-0. Fourth down and 7. Ball at the 34 of Northwest Missouri. They send Justin Dean in motion. Left to right. Straight drop back. Looking. Throwing across the middle. Got a receiver at the 17-yard line. First down and 10, Ouachita. It was Tucker Swoboda.
And good patience that time from Riley Harms. He had an open receiver to the far side of the field, but he was drifting to the close side of the field. There were more receivers coming this way and just waited for Swoboda to get open, was able to get it in, and nice catch by Swoboda. Good protection by that offensive front. Now Washington's down inside the red zone.
They'll say at the 15, but as you said, in the red zone, trailing 7-0. Tigers need points. Trips to the right side this time as they convert on fourth down. Called quarterback draw, not going to go for much. That time on the tackle, Sam Phillips, a senior linebacker. Second down and about 9.5. They're going to give him about a half yard maybe, Richard.
And
that's
this
it.
This is a great Northwest defense. Where they are susceptible is through the air, though. They've given up over 200 yards a game through the air, about 217 a game. So, like you said, Harms is going to have to hit some of those passes in this game.
Yeah, as goes Harms, will go Washita's offense today. I truly believe that. Trips to the right side this time for Ouachita. Harms, man comes through untouched, and he's sacked. Jeff, nobody that time picked up Zach Howard, and Harms couldn't do anything but go down.
Howard, really fine move on the right guard that time. He got by him quickly, and the right guard was right there to help Mr. Harms up, knowing that he had made that mistake, create a third down and long.
Third down and 15, ball at the 20. Ouachita trailing 7-0, 5:50 left in the first quarter. Again, trips to the far side, one man to the near side. Harms sets up, got one-on-one coverage in the end zone, and it's broken up. Really nice play in the end zone that time, Richard, by Northwest Missouri's Travon Peak.
Yeah, they're trying to jump ball to Justin Dean down there, and Dean was able to almost had one last week just like that. This one was just tipped away, and he never really had a chance. Good defense there, and Washington's going to settle for the field goal as they got in the red zone and lost 5 yards.
This is a 37-yard attempt for Gabe Goodman from here in Arkadelphia. Snap, hold, kick. It is good, and Washington is on the board. Our score with 5:35 remaining, clock still running for some reason, they need to stop it, is Ouachita trailing Northwest Missouri 7-3. Ouachita football 2022 presented by Visit Hot Springs continues from Cliff Harris Stadium in Arkadelphia in 30 seconds here on the Ouachita Football Network.
Our town. A place for new beginnings, stalwart pine trees, reuniting with old friends. Whether you find yourself here for a ball game, a wedding, or just to catch up with those you love, we want to invite you to be a guest on our front porch. A place to sit back and watch the world go by. A place where time seems to slow down. Our home away from home. Welcome back. Captain Henderson House, now accepting reservations.
Ended in a 37-yard field goal that was good by Gabe Goodman, now 8-for-8 on the year. Washita's offense has scored 3 points in this football game here in the first quarter. Northwestern's defense has scored 7, so the Tigers trail it by 4, 5:31 left in the first.
As you can tell by his voice, the football doctor playing injured today. I'm proud of him coming off of injured reserve to play in this crucial playoff game.
And not just today, Rex. He called the high school game last night, too. So,
coming off the injured reserve. Thank you, Dr. Rude. And so Ouachita's defense will come back on now. The defense hadn't allowed any points. It's the Northwest defense that put points on the board for the Bearcats. Kick will be taken at the 5, return to the 10, missed tackle, but not the second one. Out over the 25 to the 26-yard line. On the return for Northwest was Kashawn Griffin.
This is a really good return team for Northwest. Ouachita also has a really good coverage team. That's a bit of a subplot to watch in this game. Both teams have very, very good special teams, and I have a feeling you might see that come into play today.
I agree. First down and 10, two quality programs. Ouachita ranked number 3. Northwest ranked number 8, but I have to feel Northwest is kind of the favorite just because of all their playoff tradition, Jeff.
They are accustomed to being in the playoffs. They're accustomed to being in the championship game, so this is quite a program.
They've played up north 10 national championship games through the years. Oh, there's a tackle in the backfield for a loss. Great job by Ouachita's Dawson Miller.
Dawson Miller read that the whole way. Jay Harris never had a chance to get ahead of steam, and Miller gets in there and tackles him from behind around the ankles. Great tackle, and it's the second time they've started a drive with a one-yard loss on a run play on first down.
Second and 11 from the 25. ONC out of the shotgun, one running back set to his left. He's going to pass out into the left flats. Tigers are there. The tackle's made immediately. Again at the 25-yard line. Several were there, including Rovell Carter, and it's going to bring up third and 11, Richard.
Just tried a little wide receiver, kind of a little bit of a tunnel screen there, and Rovell Carter and Anthony Freeman are both defensive linemen, and they're out there reading that play and making the tackle. Good play there by the defense, and now brings up a third and 11 here for the Bearcats.
All right, let's see if this Ouachita defense can get a stop. Bearcats lead 7-3, 4:24 left in the first quarter of play. Out of the shotgun, Hohensick's got some time, passes across the middle, caught at the 41 for a first down. Beautiful catch that time, Jeff, by Rashad Shelton.
Shelton was wide open in the middle of the field as he made a late cut, and the defender didn't get there with him. But he had to dive to make the catch. It was beautiful just before it hit the turf. Good play on third down for Northwest.
16-yard gain, Richard, on third and 11.
Yeah, Ouachita just in a deep zone, and they were playing with the deeper players and let the underneath go, and that was the underneath route.
On first down and 10, Hohensey hands it off up the middle, going to go for about 3 yards on the carry. Jay Harris for the Bearcats.
So far, it's both teams are doing good against the run. It's been the passing that both teams are going to look to have to rely on. Of course, neither team will abandon the run.
Dawson Miller on the tackle for Ouachita. Second down and 7 for Northwest Missouri. Northwest leads 7-3, 3:25 left. First quarter. ONC out of the shotgun again. Two men to his left, one to his right. He's going to pass again. Sets up, going deep this time, and he overthrows his intended receiver. Intended receiver on the play, Kashawn Griffin. They went for the home run ball that time, Richard.
Yeah, good coverage by Anthony Hayes, though. They were running step for step, and neither one of them had much of a beat on that ball. It was overthrown by about 5 or 6 yards. Now, third and 11 a moment ago, they were able to convert for a big pass down the field. This time, a third and 7. We'll see what the Ouachita defense can come up with as they dropped into a deep zone on the last one, and it hurt them. We'll see what the defensive coordinator pulls up. Coach Thompson pulls up here for the Tigers.
Tigers trail 7-3. Let's see if they can get a third and 7 stop here. Hohensey appears to be changing the play. He's got two wide receivers to either side. Here is the snap, straight drop, drops some more, looks, passes across the middle of the field, caught at the 30, inside the 30, first down, Bearcats, bringing it up yet again, Jeff, Kashawn Griffin.
Good play by Griffin. There were two receivers in the same area, usually a mistake, but the defenders couldn't get around one of the receivers and get to the ball, and so turned into a big gainer. Nice catch on the play.
Two huge third down conversions on this drive already, Richard.
Yeah, I got to get better pressure than that. That was just too long as the receiver drug
all
the way across the field that time.
Yeah, he had all day. There was no pressure on Hohensey whatsoever. This time he's going to pitch it on the ground and going down to the 22-yard line is Jamar Moya.
Well, this is a Ouachita defense that we've talked about all year. They give up yards. When you get in the red zone, they've only allowed 12 touchdowns and 30 chances. Now, a moment ago, the offense was in the red zone and had to come away with three. We'll see if they're able to force the Bearcats into the same, as they're not in the red zone yet, but they are at the 21-yard line.
Yep, they'll give him a 6-yard gain, so call it second down and 4 for the Bearcats, trying to add to a 7-3 lead with 2:10 left in the first quarter. They come out of the pistol this time. Let's see if they go back to the ground game. They will. Handoff over right guard, and it's going to be no gain that time. Good job by Ouachita. Leading the way for the Tigers, Richard, Matthew Burton, the freshman out of Longview, Texas.
Yeah, they did a good job, really. Just the pile. There was just a big pile there and nowhere to go, and Ouachita was able to come in and clean up. Another third down. Ouachita's done a good job forcing third down today, but they have not been able to get off, or this drive, but haven't been able to get off the field on the last two.
Yeah, they're not getting third down stops. Let's see if they can get one here and at least force a field goal attempt. Third and 4 from the 21-yard line. Owensy with Moya set to his left. I expect him to be passing, however. He will. Straight drop back. Quick pass. Wide open receiver. Down to the 12. First down.
Yeah, that's just the slot receiver that time.
That was too easy.
Didn't have somebody up close on him, and that's an easy just run 3 or 4 yards down the field and turn, and the ball's on him.
Keegan Sturdy with the reception. They will spot it at the 12. So a fresh set of downs in the red zone for the Bearcats of Northwest Missouri, already leading 7-3 with a minute left in the first quarter. On first down and 10, they will come out of the pistol. Owensy, hands off, seam, down to the 10-yard line.
More of
gain
a hole.
Of about 2.
Looked like there was more of a hole than there was. Ouachita did a good job closing that up as Jax Miller got in there and got the tackle.
It was Jay Harris on the carry. They're going to mark it just between the 9 and the 10, so it's second and about 7.5 is what they need for a first down, as the ball is now inside the Ouachita 10-yard line. Moya, the running back, set to the left of his quarterback, Owensy. Owensy's going to pass. Goes left side into the end zone. Too hard. Incomplete. Had a receiver, but pretty good coverage for Ouachita. He tried to thread the needle to Travon Alexander, Richard, and couldn't get it in there.
Yeah, Alexander went to the ground, but the pass was behind him. That would have been if he makes that catch, Alexander could be playing on Sundays, as that was low and behind him.
Third down. This is definitely a 4-point play right here.
This is where the Ouachita defense has been really good all year, right?
They can force a field goal here. On third down, 7.5 needed for a first down as the ball spotted at the 9.5. Out of the shotgun. Owensy takes the low snap. He's in trouble. Having to scramble. Gets away from the sack. Now he's going to run. He's still looking. Now he throws and it's knocked away. Great job by Ouachita's Andrew Hayes blocking and knocking away that pass, Jeff, on the last play of the first quarter.
What an amazing play. It looked like there'd be a sack and a huge loss and a long field goal. Instead, he kept it alive, but when he threw to the end zone, that man was there. He's done a great job this year. Andrew Hayes coming through again.
At the end of the first quarter, Northwest Missouri 7, Ouachita 3. Ouachita Football 2022 presented by Pissin Hot Springs continues in 60 seconds here on the Ouachita Football Network.
Start your holiday season at Ouachita Baptist University's 30th annual Festival of Christmas. With new music, classic favorites, fun characters, and stirring moments, there is something magical for everyone. Whether it's your 13th time or your first, you do not want to miss this exciting tradition December 2nd and 3rd. Join us for Festival of Christmas. Tickets are on sale now at obu.edu/boxoffice.
Okay.
A a 27-yard attempt from Cole Lammel on the first play of the second quarter in an attempt to give Northwest Missouri a 10-3 lead in this NCAA playoff game from Cliff Harris Stadium. Set right in the middle of the field as we start the second quarter of play. Here's the snap. Hold. Lammel's kick doesn't have a lot, but it makes it through, and it is good, and it's again a 7-point Northwest Missouri lead. The Bearcats of Northwest Missouri have 10. The Tigers of Ouachita have 3. Ouachita Football 2022, presented by Visit Hot Springs, continues from Cliff Harris Stadium in Arkadelphia in 30 seconds here on the Ouachita Football Network.
That was a 13-play drive, but it did not end in a touchdown. It ended in a field goal, a very unusual-looking field goal, but it didn't make it over the crossbar from 27 yards out, and so it is Northwest 10 and Ouachita 3, 14:54 left in the second quarter.
So it's still a one-possession game, but at some point, Richard, this Ouachita offense is going to need to get a touchdown on the board.
Yeah, they were helped out by 30 yards of penalties on the last drive. They've only got 24 yards so far of offense, and the run game has not been there. It doesn't mean you abandon it, but you got to do something to open it up a little bit.
Absolutely. They're going to have to start hitting some short passes is what they're going to have to do. Short kick. Let's see if Zaylin Falls can get a good return. He does, over the 30. Out to about the 40-yard line, just as we saw him do last week against Henderson. Richard, he gives Ouachita a very good field position as the Tigers will start at their 40.
And he's mad because the very last possible person got him or he was off to the races there, Rex. And how many times have we said that for the last couple years?
Oh, he looks like he's going to break it every time, doesn't he?
And Ouachita might need to get him on the field on offense, maybe get him at receiver or in the running back, somehow get the ball to him. His speed plays.
Yeah, get him in the open field somehow. First down and 10 from the 40. T.J. Cole's in there as the running back as they come out of the pistol. Give to Cole, running room this time, over the 45, he's over the 50, he's in the Northwest Missouri territory to the Bearcat, 46-yard line. Jeff, that's a 14-yard gain to start the drive.
Really nice play, looked like it was going to go to the left, he came back to the right and had some open yardage, a very nice run, best run of the day for any running back for a Ouachita Tigers, and not surprisingly, it's the All-American Cole.
That looked like the old T.J. Cole, didn't it, Richard?
It did, and what Dr. Root said, I like what they did, they showed power to the left and went back to the right with it.
Tigers set on the near hash mark. Cole to the right of his quarterback now as they will come out of the shotgun. Got trips to the near side. Pumps once, Riley Harms. Now runs and is going to be out of bounds at the 45 after a gain of just one.
Trying to throw it down the line to Justin Dean, but Northwest quickly blew that up and he wisely said, I'm just going to tuck this and run because there was nobody else out. Everybody's blocking on that one. That play was just blown up. Washaw's lucky to get a yard on it.
Second down and 9, ball from the 45. Tigers trail 10-3, 13:57 left to go in the first half. Playoff football at Cliff Harris Stadium. Come out of the pistol this time. They're going to pass this time out of the pistol and drop. Good night. You've got to hang on to those, Richard. And unable to do so was Justin Dean that time.
Yeah, he was looking where he was going to run and didn't look it in. That was going to be get him about 2 yards away from the first down if he's able to make that catch. And now third and 9, these are not the situations you want to be. Ouachita's not been able to find Connor Flanagan today. The Bearcats have done a good job covering him up. They've got to find him. This would be a great time to do it.
Yeah, that one hurt, that drop. Third down and 9. Let's see if they can convert with trips to the left side. One man to the right side. Harm sets up, forced out of the pocket. On the run, coming to his right, throws on the run and caught inside the 30, and they say out of bounds, Jeff.
Yeah, Hightower made a nice catch, but came down out of bounds. He tried to stick a foot, but got on the line, incomplete.
And Hightower was going across the middle, and I know they're going to let things go in the playoffs, but he was almost yanked down to the ground. That's when they've got a call. He stayed up and did a good job running with his quarterback, but unfortunately the ball just let him a little out of bounds. Hightower's played a little bit more the last couple weeks, and he's looked good.
So Joe Couch is going to have to punt it away again, and with a seven-point lead, Northwest about to get the football back. Fourth and nine, Ouachita, as they moved into Bearcat territory but could not get points. High kick by Couch. It's going to bounce, and it takes a bit of a Northwest bounce. Let's see where they said it was touched. It's going to be inside the 20. They're going to finally mark it, Richard, at the 16, so that's where the Bearcats will go to work.
Yeah, high end-over-end punt that time from Joe Couch. Didn't look great, but it was doing exactly what he wanted to do. And the Ouachita defense gave up three on the last one, but they've been playing all right today. They need to get a stop here and get the ball back to the offense, which is having a little bit more trouble.
First down and 10 from the 16 as Northwest brings its offense back out, leading 10-3 with 13:22 left in the first half of this first-round NCAA playoff game from Arkadelphia. Bearcats in white helmets, white jerseys, green numerals, and green pants. The big green, the most historic program in Division II. Here is the give to Moya, coming right. Got some running room this time over the 20. They're going to give him all the way to the 23-yard line, Richard, and that's 7 yards on first down.
Yeah, just a heck of a run there. Kind of had a convoy of blockers running with him. That's just power right there. And a great first down play from the Bearcats. It really opens up the playbook here on second down. And what they did going down the field, Rex, is they hit some runs and some short passes, and they on a couple third downs hit a little bit deeper. But they want those runs and short passes is the bread and butter. That's what they're trying to get, and that's a perfect play here on second down and short.
They set up on the far hash mark this time on second and three. They'll go back to Moya on the ground. He's got the first down and more as he will go out over the 30, out to the 32, and they move from the 16 to the 32, Jeff, on two running plays now.
Yeah, this is very good scouting by Northwest. Ouachita will alternate its defensive linemen, and some of their stalwarts are not in right now, so they've gone to the run. They've been able to get some blocks and get some yardage.
First down and 10 from the 32-yard line, leading 10-3. Northwest Missouri moves right to left as it's now mostly clear, as the clouds have cleared out in Arkadelphia. Straight drop back, throw out into the left flats, got a receiver at the 30. At the 40, all the way out to about the 45-yard line goes the Bearcats, Jaden Brady.
Well, that's a long developing play, and the Tigers got to see that because they get Brady out there. They also have a receiver just hanging out there waiting to be his lead blocker, and Ouachita just wasn't paying attention because they didn't see that play developing, and that was where Holtze was going the entire time, and they got to be able to see that one coming. That was an easy pass and an easy first down.
Yeah, that was a 13-yard gain for the Bearcats. First down and 10 from the 45. ONC sets up out of the shotgun. Now he steps up, appears to be changing the play on first down and 10. Set on the near hash mark. Now we got a flag down.
False start.
Yep, back them up 5.
They were holding there for a long time. The old adage, the longer you hold there, the more chance you're going to jump off.
So it'll be first down and 15. Northwest working from its 40-yard line. Leading 10-3, we're down to 11:33 left in the first half on what's been a pretty fast first half so far. Lights are on, but when the clouds left, they left, Jeff. It's blue skies now.
It's looking very, very nice outside right now. A big crowd has turned out for the football game today.
Yep, chilly, but now sunny in Arkadelphia. Owensy going to pass, rolling to his right, under pressure, has to dump it off. Good pressure by Ouachita, Richard, and he just had to throw the football away that time.
Yeah, they brought a blitz and a Jax Miller coming up the field pretty quickly, and that's a smart play by Owensy. There was nowhere to go with it, and he's just going to throw it away and fight again for another down because it will be second down, as that was first and 15 because of the false start.
Second and 15 now from the 40-yard line. Bearcats set up on the near hash mark. Hoensie again out of the shotgun with one running back set to his right. That's Moya. Now he sends him in motion. Hoensie throws a quick one across the middle of the field out to the 47-yard line, but a tackle made quickly by Ouachita's Jax Miller. They needed 15. They picked up 7 of it. Here's another one of those big third down plays, Richard. It's 3rd and 8 from the Ouachita 47.
Yeah, Ouachita wasn't able to get off the field on the last one until the field goal. They did force that field goal. There were a few in the middle of the field that they gave up, and they've got to convert, or they've got to force the fourth down, force the punt.
So 3rd and 8. Let's see if the Tigers can get a stop right now. Low snap. Hoensie picks it up. Sets up, goes across the middle, and got a receiver at the 39 of Ouachita. He's done it again on 3rd down. He's been very successful, Jeff, on 3rd and long. That's Trevon Alexander with the catch.
And he's going to limp off the field, hit hard at the end of the play. But I tell you what, Hoensie has looked very, very impressive. Comes in hitting almost 70% of his passes, and even downfield he can throw very much on target, came up with another big third down conversion.
1st down and 10, ball at the Ouachita 39-yard line. Give to Moya. Moya coming right, and he's going to have 4 yards to the 35-yard line.
Ouachita on 3rd down several times now has brought 3 in pressure and dropped everybody else back in coverage, trying to keep an eye on the pass, but they've been giving them up. So I think they're going to have to change that a little bit, maybe bring some pressure. You gamble a little bit. But so far, 4 of 6 are the Bearcats on 3rd down, and that's not working.
2nd and 6 from the Ouachita 35. Northwest trying to add to a 10-3 lead now as they move deep into Ouachita territory. On 2nd down, Hoensie will go with an empty backfield, and the Ouachita defense uses a timeout. We will pause. 9:28 left first half. Northwest Missouri 10, Ouachita 3. Ouachita football 2022, presented by Visit Hot Springs, continues from Cliff Harris Stadium in Arkadelphia in 30 seconds here on the Ouachita Football Network.
If you or a loved one gets hurt in an accident, you need true care and concern. You can hand us everything, the bills, the paperwork, and anything else you need help with,
so you can focus on recovering from your injury.
That's why people turn to the Taylor King Law Firm.
You need an attorney with integrity and experience in dealing with the complex details.
We do everything we can to relieve the stress and take care of your family.
If you're injured in an accident, call 1-800-CAR-WRECK.
We'll be on your side, by your side.
Left, we're in the second quarter. It's Northwest Missouri 10, Ouachita Baptist University 3. Northwest, though, is on the move. Very important defensive effort now coming from the Ouachita Tigers. They don't want to fall down by more than one possession, and it's 7 points right now.
Well, and based on that last field goal, that did not look pretty. This may be 4 down territory here,
yep,
guys.
I agree. 2nd down and 6. Ball at the 35. It's Northwest Missouri State. Resumes play here in the second quarter, trying to add to its lead. Hoensie sets up blitz zone, gets it off to Moya, and Moya's going to be tackled immediately by Ouachita's Jax Miller. They didn't pick up the blitz at all, Richard, and he just had to get rid of the football.
Well, Ouachita called the blitz, and there was also a screen, so everybody was getting back there, but Jax Miller heads up play, realizing, oh, gosh, they're going to try to hit a quick outlet, and he found Moya and made the tackle. Again, another one of these big
third
down.
Here we go.
It may be 4 down territory here, but at least get the 4 down and figure that, 4th down and figure that out. Ouachita's been bringing 3, dropping everybody in coverage. We'll see if they bring pressure here.
3rd and 7 from the Ouachita 36. They set up on the near hash mark with an empty backfield for Hoensie. Trips right, 2 men left. He sets up. He's got time. He throws right. Got a receiver at the 15. And they're going to have another 1st down in the red zone. He's done it again, Jeff, on 3rd and long. Keegan Sturdy on the catch.
That was a beautiful pass deep to the right side. Sturdy got there. The defender chasing him could not quite get there. It was a beautiful pass. Good pattern and a 1st down.
Yeah, it was a good route. Turned around Gibson. Ouachita brought a 4th man on pressure. Just couldn't get home. But that was just a great pass that time from Hoensie.
Huge play. A 22-yard gain. So knocking on the door, trying to make this a 2-possession game now, are the Bearcats. On 1st down, pass out into the right flats, gain out to the 11-yard line where the tackle is made by Andrew Hayes, and will bring up second down.
Yeah, good job by Hayes as they got it to the tight end out there, Cole Hennenbro, and Hayes made a nice tackle. This is, we've said, Ouachita does a good job in the red zone. They've only, in 31 red zone trips this year, they've only given up 12 touchdowns. So you got to hold for a field goal here, though, the way this Northwest Missouri State Bearcat defense plays.
Second and 7 from the Ouachita 11. One running back set to Hohensee's left. He's got two receivers right, one left, got a tight end also to his right side. Looking left, throwing into the end zone, incomplete. Coverage that time, Jeff, by Ouachita Stephen Weston, the freshman from Whitehall.
Boy, the receiver Griffin really had his hand on the defensive back, but I tell you what, the officials are being consistent. They're letting everybody play today.
Yeah, and Griffin wanted the interference there, but he had the stiff arm on the Ouachita player. There's just a lot of contact both ways for receivers down the field, and Ouachita's got to adjust. Say, all right, they're going to let you do it. Let's play like that.
Here we go again, Richard, third and long.
Yeah, and this is field goal territory again, so make a big play here for this Tiger defense.
Third down and 7. Empty backfield for Hohensee. Looking to his left. Gets the pass off. Too high. Too high. They threw a flag. They're going to call interference on Ouachita.
I saw less contact on that than I've seen on a few other ones. But
in the end zone,
they're going to call a little tighter. Hohensee almost got hit from the blind side. He got that ball out just in time. They're going to call that interference on the safety.
Dante Gibson. Yep. Man, oh, man.
Yeah, there was less contact on that than several of the other ones. But we just said you got to adjust, that's difficult.
If they come back and score a touchdown, that's going to be a 4-point penalty, Jeff, because they would have had to kick a field goal there.
And he reached over the right shoulder of the receiver. The ball, I think, went past them both anyway.
First and goal at the 2. Yep. First down and goal from 2 yards away. Running back will be Jay Harris this time. So let's see if they go back to the ground on first and goal. Harris set just behind and to the left of his quarterback. He will get the give, and he's going to be stopped a yard short. Second and goal. Now they're going to say in there. He is in there. Second effort by Jay Harris, and it is a 2-possession lead now for Northwest Missouri State.
Yeah, second effort. Looked like he was going to be stopped, and they got a lineman in there that helped him push, and he got forward across into the end zone. One of the officials was signaling what looked like a false start, but I guess he's now changed. I don't know what he was. That didn't happen.
And so Cole Lammel will come on and attempt the extra point. Snap, hold. Lammel's extra point is up, and it is good. And it's all Northwest Missouri right now. Northwest Missouri State 17. Ouachita only 3, 7:12 left in the first half. Ouachita Football 2022, presented by Visit Hot Springs, continues from Cliff Harris Stadium in Arkadelphia in 30 seconds here on the Ouachita Football Network.
Seven minutes, 12 seconds left before halftime. Northwest has claimed its biggest lead of the game at 17-3 over Ouachita. That was the best drive of the game, 12 plays, 84 yards.
Ouachita just cannot get the stop on third and long, Richard. It is that simple right now.
Yeah, they can't get off the field on third down, and that's what it's boiled down to is Northwest Missouri the Bearcats have forced Ouachita into some third downs and longs and gotten off the field, and Ouachita has not been able to do that to them.
Yeah, Ouachita can't get off the field. Only 3 points in this first half. Kick taken at the 20. Short one, nice return out over the 35. Out to the 37-yard line goes Justin Dean.
They tried to kick it away from Dean on the last time, left it in the field a little bit more, and almost got burned by Zaylin Falls taking it to the house. That time they made sure, Rex, to kick it over to that side on Justin Dean. But still, Washita's getting good field position like they get all year because so many people are so worried about Zaylin Falls on the returns, and they're going to have it at 37-yard line, but they've got to convert. And I'll say it again, they've got to get Connor Flanagan the ball.
Yeah, I agree. Let's see if this offense can get anything going now. Trailing by 14. First down and 10, ball at the 37-yard line. Two receivers to either side for Ouachita. Kendall Briles in the game. Kendall Givens in the game now for Ouachita. And Kendall Givens goes up over the 40 to the 41. Jeff, I saw you kind of move. Same way, he seems so close, Givens, to breaking it sometimes.
Yeah, I think he and I moved at the same time as he jumped off the ground because he had just broken into the secondary and had room to run if he had stayed on his feet.
Still, it was a gain of five, Richard. That's a good way to start a drive.
Yeah, Ouachita will take that on first down. I think they'll go back to the run here.
Yep, Givens will come out of the pistol this time behind Riley Harms. On second and five, they do give it to Givens, and he is going to be just a yard short.
That's a great job just reading the hole that time.
Yep.
As he was able to kind of find a hole and make a cutback. It's going to bring up a big third down. You were talking about third downs earlier so far, Rex. Ouachita 0-5. The Bearcats 5-7. That's the difference in this ballgame. Ouachita needs to convert this one.
Third down and one from the 46, so you've badly got to convert here. You just cannot be giving the ball back to Northwest Missouri when it has a 14-point lead. Out of the pistol, Givens. Now they're going to go with the direct snap to Kendall Givens on third down and one. Givens over left tackle, first down Ouachita. And that's old-fashioned Ouachita football there. But we've got a flag down, Richard.
Yeah, it was thrown in the middle of the line of scrimmage right as the tackle was being made. I think it's either going to be a hold or hands to the face. We'll see what it's going to be. If that's a hold, that's killer.
Shot block on Washington.
That's 15.
Absolute killer.
That's 15 yards. That's the second shot block we've seen today, one on the Bearcats, one on the Tigers. I think we've seen two all year.
Otherwise, you would have had a first down out near midfield. Now it's going to be third and very long.
And this is a team
that's just devastating right there.
Yeah, the official was explaining it to two of the offensive linemen. I think there was some confusion about why that call was made. I didn't see it. It perhaps was an absolutely accurate call, but an unusual one against Ouachita.
Devastating penalty. Third and 16. Going to have to come up with a big play here. Riley Harms passes right side, and he overthrows his intended receiver. Ouachita crowd asking for some defensive holding.
Well,
they will not get it. So Washita's going to punt it back, and Northwest's going to have a chance to make this a three-possession game, Richard, before halftime.
There was some defensive holding there because the jersey's off the shoulder, but at the same time, that ball was too long, and Dean never really had a chance there. I don't think just the go routes to the outside receiver is going to beat the Bearcats. You got to have something maybe across the middle of the field looking for Flanagan because even if that ball, there's no holding and that ball's right on the money, that's a very tough contested catch. That's at best a 50-50 ball.
Yep, it's all Bearcats right now. Here is Couch's punt. It's another good one taken at the 25. Return room up over the 40-yard line. And it's going to be great field position. But, Richard, there is a flag down on the field.
That was a heck of a tackle by Tucker Sabota, getting his arm there for the tackle. The flag was thrown from the back. It wasn't on the tackle. The tackle was made around the ankle, so this is almost certainly going to be a holding or a block in the back on the Bearcats.
Holding on the Bearcats. And, boy, it's getting at the point now. It's still the first half. But, Jeff, you cannot get three possessions down in this football game. It is absolutely essential that Ouachita force a punt on this possession.
Well, Ouachita gave up a touchdown on a turnover. Right now, that's exactly what this defense needs to get their team back in the game.
Yeah, defense only giving up one touchdown, though. They've given up two long drives, and one ended up in a field goal. But don't even want the field goal. Need to get this ball back and get
absolutely
the offense in good field position. 5 minutes left to go before half and see if the offense can get something going. You go in halftime down 17-10. It's very different than if Northwest goes down and scores and it's 20-3 or even worse than that.
Northwest Missouri State with a 17-3 lead over Ouachita, and they have the football back. First down and 10
Got a stoppage in
and
play.
And what now?
I think they're going to have to respot the football, maybe?
Well, the official had said...
Or I think they're changing out. They're moving the hash marks.
Moving the hash mark. Yeah. Okay. So first down and 10 at the 27-yard line is where they have it spotted after the penalty. They originally marked that penalty back to the 25, then they moved it to the 27, then they moved the hash marks. First down and 10 from the 27, set on the near hash mark. Now, Hoensie gives on the ground, running room, out over the 30, out over the 35, all the way out to the 39-yard line goes Northwest Missouri's Jay Harris.
Just a heck of a cutback that time. There was nothing to the right, and he just was patient and cut back and cut back and cut back and finally found some running room and got the first down. And really everything's working for the Bearcats right now. Is the run game's not gashing the Tigers for 20, 30 yards. They're giving up 5 to 7 yards a carry. But really
13.
The difference, yeah, Hoensie has been the difference on third down, and Washtenaw's been dropping in zone, and he's been picking them apart.
They're going to spot it all the way up to the 40 now. So first down and 10. Edge of the ball almost touching the 40-yard line. Hoensie with an empty backfield now on first down. Let's see if he passes or quarterback draws. He's going to pass out of the right flats. Another first down out to the 50-yard line. And Northwest just having its way right now, Jeff, bringing in that one for the Bearcats was Cole Hembrough, the big 6'3 tight end.
Well, the safety came in for the blitz, and so they just dumped it to the tight end on his side. Got an easy catch. Really smart offense play. The quarterback really a fine, fine player and doing a great job here to lead his team today.
They've quickly moved from the 27 out to midfield. One running back set to the left. That's Moya. Moya will get it on the ground, flag down. This one's going to come back. He's got a first down and more, but it's out there where you're usually going to see a penalty on Northwest, Richard.
It's free play. That's offsides on Ouachita.
Oh, okay.
Anthony Freeman jumped.
All right, so it was Freeman.
Sir, maybe not. I don't think it was Freeman. It was that. Yeah, it was Freeman, that defensive end out there. But it's not going to matter because Northwest is going to decline that penalty.
Wow. And so it is going to be a big first down inside the 40 to the 36-yard line, Jeff. And here come the Bearcats again.
Yeah, they are looking strong right now. And with a 14-point lead, Ouachita very much needs to get to halftime without more damage being done. 3:55 left, clock running.
First down and 10, ball at the Ouachita 36-yard line. Trips to the near side. Gift on the left and only about 2 yards this time for Harris.
I think the ball may have
now
come out, but Harris
say only
is back on
about
it.
A yard. Yep. So second and long. But again, Hoensie has just been a master so far this afternoon.
Well,
converting on third and long.
And Ouachita has not been able to get pressure on him, and so it's hard when you're sitting back there, only a three-man rush, and he's got plenty of time to find an open receiver, but he's done a good job finding the open receiver. It's not contested catches generally. It's wide-open receivers.
Second and 9, ball at the Ouachita 35-yard line. Trips to the right side, one man to the left side. Hoensie's got a receiver right side at the 30. Forced out of bounds inside the 30, down at the 30 at the 28-yard line. That's a gain of 7. So now, Jeff, we're looking at third and short, third and 2 for the Bearcats.
Third down and 2, and they'll make a few substitutions. Harris coming back in at running back, and he has been a big strong one today. He'll check in. We might see him run the ball, even though this could be a passing situation as well.
And he's just a freshman, Harris. Third down and 2. From the 28. Let's see what Hoensie does. Does he pass on third and short? Nope, he's going to give to Harris. Harris breaks one tackle, has enough for a first down as they mark his forward motion down to the 26, Richard.
Yeah, they gave him just past the marker. He was pushed backwards, but did have the forward progress. As you said, the 26 first down marker was between the 26 and 27-yard line, so they're not going to have to measure. First down, 2:29 left to go in the half. Washtenaw's got to stand up and not allow a touchdown here. Field goal hurts, but not as bad as a touchdown.
Northwest trying to add to a 17-3 lead. It has been all Bearcats in this first half. First down and 10 now. Ball at the Ouachita 26-yard line. Moya, the running back, to the left of his quarterback. Give is to Moya. Moya is inside the 20, going down that sideline. Ouachita just cannot stop this Northwest team. Moya is all the way down to the 5-yard line, or make it the 6, Jeff. First and goal.
Good speed on the right side. Tell you what, the defense has played well until this drive, but they look tired right now. The offense hasn't been able to keep them off the field.
No, they haven't. They've spent a lot of this first half on the field. And Northwest gets the football to start the third quarter.
Yeah, especially the second quarter. They've been out there the entire time.
Yeah, it's getting ugly now. First down and 10. Ball at the 6-yard line. Harris, the running back. Harris coming to his right, circling, breaks a tackle, gets to the 2, gets to the 1, gets to the end zone. Touchdown, Northwest Missouri State. And they have a 3-possession lead now with 1:35 left in the first half.
And you can tell a little tired there because Ouachita had him hit at the 2 or 3 yard line, and he's just able to lean on him and get into the end zone. It looked like they were going to have him stopped, but really what I've been impressed with on Harris, he did that time, is some of his cuts. His jump cuts are powerful and quick, and that's really throwing off some of this Tiger defense. Is he's able to, a few times, kind of make the cutback where they're not expecting it.
Cole Lammel will attempt to add the extra point now with 1:35 left in the first half. Snap, hold, kick. It is no good. He missed that one, but it's a 20-point lead for the visitors. Northwest Missouri State 23, Ouachita 3 with 1:35 left in the first half. Ouachita Football 2022 presented by Visit Hot Springs continues from Cliff Ferris Stadium in Arkadelphia in 30 seconds here on the Ouachita Football Network.
Hello, I'm Taylor King. I've been practicing law for over 34 years, but long before that, I learned what it takes to be a good lawyer. Caring for others. You could say it's a family trait, and it's one I've passed along to my kids. If you've been involved in an accident, call 1-800-CAR-WRECK. I want to help.
We want to help, to be on your side, by your side. I'm Austin King. Now, I've not been practicing law quite as long as my dad, but thanks to him, I know what it takes to be a good lawyer. I guess you could say it runs in the family.
1:35 left in the second quarter, and the Ouachita Tigers would like to be able to throw a counterpunch here, trailing by 20 now. After that touchdown by Northwestern, it's Northwest 23, and Ouachita 3.
So the Tigers get the ball back, some time left on the clock, but they hadn't been able to do much on offense thus far this afternoon. Kick taken at the 13, brought out over the 20 by Justin Dean, brought out to the 25, and that's where Ouachita will set up 75 yards away, Richard.
Yeah, they got 1:27 left to go. You know, last week, Ouachita, when they had to, went down the field at the end of the first half and the end of the game, just throwing the ball, not even worrying about the run. That's when their offense looked the best. We'll see if Ouachita is able to do that here because they're going to have to be throwing the football. Ouachita's not gotten T.J. Cole in the a pass. Let's see if they can get him on a wheel route or something in the open field, get him the ball. Also, Flanagan hadn't touched the ball today. They need to get those guys in the open field.
On first down and 10 from the 25-yard line, Harms does get it out there to Connor Flanagan. He gets over the 30-yard line to the 32, and that's a quick 7 yards.
Yeah, they just did a good job just dragging him across the formation, and Harms did a good job eluding some pressure and getting the ball to him. And they're adding 4 seconds to the clock here as Flanagan did go out of bounds. But I think you're going to have to see this at the end of this half and then in the second half as well, Rex, because the normal Ouachita offense running the football is not working.
Reset the game clock, man. And there he did it finally, 2nd and 3 from the 32. Tigers trail 23-20, working left to right with a 2nd and 3 from their 32-yard line. Riley Harms going to pass, forced out of the pocket again. He just hadn't had much time today. Runs for his life, goes up over the 30. First down and more as he goes out to about the 34. Now what do we have?
It's in the secondary. I think there's going to be a very, very late pass interference call as Tucker Sabota tried to make a cut. He was almost wrapped up and had to duck under the defensive back. And I think they're going to call an interference on that. As Harms was trying to go deep to Sabota, did a good job tucking it and running.
And Harms did have the first down.
Yeah. Yeah.
He needed to get to the 35, and he got to the 35. Hold it. Yep, defensive holding. So that helps, Jeff. Adds to your field position. Still got time to get down there and get some points.
home crowd cheering for that call. They had been hoping for that call for a while now, and they got it. Key time. Ouachita still got a chance.
And so out to the 45 now, Richard. You're 55 yards away, but you've got a minute 20 left.
Yeah, a minute 20 left, two timeouts. Really, they have plenty of time, but I don't think they're going to go to the ground here. I think they'll still be passing the football.
First down and 10, Ouachita works from its 45 with trips to the left. Harm sets up, throws right side, one-on-one coverage, and no flag down.
I'm okay with no flag on that one.
Yep.
Swoboda.
Tucker Swoboda, the intended receiver.
Tucker Swoboda trying to get there, and he's not even going to get up asking for anything. There was a little overthrown. He dove trying to get it. Ouachita normally has success on those throws being back shoulder throws to Swoboda. That time was not a back shoulder, and he just couldn't catch up to it. It was really pretty good coverage down the field by Khalil Smith.
Second down and 10, ball at the 45-yard line. Tigers trail 23-3 with a minute 14 left in the first half. Setting up, throwing, got a receiver at the 45, at the 40, at the 39-yard line. Connor Flanagan, and there's that play they've been looking for, Jeff, from Flanagan. But another flag down, this one in the Ouachita backfield.
I believe that's because they hit the quarterback just a little bit late.
That's what Harms is signaling.
Let's see, that is.
And good things happen when you get the ball to Connor Flanagan.
Wow, that will be added on to the end of the play. So Ouachita's down here in striking distance now suddenly, Richard.
And keep getting the ball to Flanagan. He was juggling that ball, Rex, and basically dodged a defender as he was juggling it and still made the catch. And hadn't been elaborate. It's just been crossing routes with him right now.
First down and 10 from the Northwest Missouri State 23. Tigers trail 23-3 in desperate need of points. Getting close with a minute 8 left in the first half. Harms pass, right side high in the air and caught at the 13-yard line. What an amazing catch by Connor Flanagan.
And he was just a great catch. Got a submarine as he was up in the air. But that's why we've been saying all game, Rex, that you got to get the ball to him.
First down and 10, gain of 10. On the play, Tigers in the red zone. Harms passing again. Can't find anybody open, and he's going to be tackled. For no gain on the tackle for Northwest Missouri State, Isaac Volstack that time. And we're going to have a timeout. 47 seconds left in the first half. Northwest Missouri 23, Ouachita 3. Ouachita Football 2022, presented by Visit Hot Springs, continues in 30 seconds here on the Ouachita Football Network.
Before halftime, Ouachita trailing Northwest Missouri 23-3, but the Tigers are driving and have a chance to pull closer here before halftime.
Went backward that time, though, Richard, second and 15 from the 18.
Yeah, I think the Bearcats are aware that Riley Harms will like to run. They kind of got a little bit of spy on him, and they got him that time. So he needs to hang in that pocket and make the throw because they're watching out for the run.
T.J. Cole set to the right of Riley Harms. Harms sets up, looks, pumps, doesn't have anybody. Hit as he throws, and it's going to be incomplete. Boy, this offense gets close, but just can't get it done so far when they get down close, Richard. Now it's third and 15 after you had a first and 10 at the 13.
Yeah, that was good pressure, and Harms is lucky he was throwing that one away. He was throwing that, and it ended up going backwards, but he was already in the throwing motion. As he got hit from behind and the front, they're talking about it. That's not intentional grounding because he was definitely trying to throw the football forward.
Now they do throw the flag.
I don't when you're hit by the front.
The quarterback was contacted prior to throwing the pass. The pass did not make it back to the original line of scrimmage. There was no receiver in the area.
I disagree with that call.
They call intentional grounding on Ouachita.
They're saying he was contacted before he threw it. He was contacted, yes, but he didn't see the contact coming from behind and the front. You can't – he thought he was going to get it away from the pressure that he had coming, and then – oh, that hurts.
He
got hit from the front and back, and he's trying to get the ball down the field. And, yeah, the ball goes to the sideways, but
that one hurts. Third and 25 from the 28. Third and 25.
I don't think I've ever seen that call, actually.
Good Lord.
They're talking about it again now.
If it can go wrong against Ouachita, it has in the first half today.
Are they talking about the spot? Because the officials are meeting again.
They marked off 10 yards from the 18 to the 28.
It would be a spot foul, I think, is what it would be. It's intentional grounding, but
40 seconds left in the first half. Northwest Missouri State with a big 23-3 lead over Ouachita. Ouachita trying to get some points on the board before we go in at halftime and at least get back within striking distance before the second half of this NCAA playoff game. Ten-second runoff also.
Well, the Bearcats allowed the Bearcats 30 seconds. Said no 10-second runoff. The Bearcats said yes, 10-second runoff. The Tigers did not take their last time out, so it'll be 30 seconds left and third down for the Tigers.
Yeah, the big number's third and 25. Washington's got forever to go. So Harms will come out of the shotgun again. Hadn't had much time today. Again, he is forced out of the pocket. Throws it down into the end zone, incomplete. And this would be a 45-yard field goal attempt from here, Jeff.
It would be, and they're trailing by 20. And that's a lot to make up, but they're going to send him out there to try to pick up three before halftime.
Yeah, you got to get at least three here, Richard.
Yeah, got to get the points. But on a cold day like this, it's not a gimme.
Oh, no. It is a 44-yard attempt from the near hash mark. 44 yards for Gabe Goodman. Near hash mark, snap, hold, Goodman's kick, trying to get there and does not. And that kind of sums up this first half for Ouachita. 13 seconds left, first half, Northwest Missouri State 23, Ouachita 3. Ouachita Football 2022, presented by Visinot Springs, continues from Cliff Harris Stadium in Arkadelphia in 30 seconds here on the Ouachita Football Network. The first half with a 23-3 Northwest Missouri lead. That concludes the first half. Stay tuned for the Electric Cooperatives of Arkansas halftime report. It's coming up in 2 minutes here on the Ouachita Football Network, presented by Visit Hot Springs.
Welcome and thank you for joining us. I'm Kaylin Clay.
And I'm Haley Shore. This is Ouachita News. Well, I've been wearing a coat to class because it has been so chilly outside. It's a different temperature than we are used to here in Arkansas. Josh Engel has our Ouachita Weather Watch.
The rest of this week is going to remain pretty cold. Tigers
temperatures are going to be in the lows of 20s, not 2. That's a typo. It's actually going to be 23. Pretty cold, not going to lie. Though, we will be seeing some sun, the sun's right there, but it's going to helpfully keep things a little bit warmer while in the sunlight. However, things will be changing pretty darn fast once we hit Thanksgiving break. As you can see on Tuesday, we're actually going to be seeing some rain. Now, honestly, more than likely, that's actually going to be happening on Wednesday and Thursday, with chances in the 50% and 60% respectively. However, with that, we're also going to be seeing some temperature changes. Temps are going to all around pretty much rise about 10 degrees throughout the rest of Thanksgiving break. So that is going to be a nice change from the cool temps we're feeling so far. Guys, earlier this week, we saw some snow in Northwest Arkansas, and some friends of mine in Fayetteville, as you can see, had some nice, cool photos of the snow. Looks beautiful. Enjoy your Thanksgiving break, Tigers. Numbers provided by AccuWeather. Back to the desk.
Thanks, Josh. It looks like Thanksgiving break will still be cold, too. Kicks for Kids, a fundraiser stem from a Wednesday night small group, has a goal of raising $12,000 to provide shoes for orphan children in Zambia. If you're interested in donating, contact Wes Guerra. They will be set up in the Student Center this week to provide more information. The Elrod Center will be assembling Thanksgiving baskets on Thursday. These baskets are filled with food and goodies to give to families in Arkadelphia around this holiday season. Contact the Elrod Center to help pack these baskets as well as help them deliver.
The 2022 Battle of the Ravine was a thriller. I don't know if I've recovered yet, but what a game. Caroline has our Roar Rundown this week.
Welcome to the Roar Rundown. I'm Caroline Derby. It's been a busy week in Ouachita Athletics, so let's get into it. To begin, the Ouachita football team won in an overtime thriller against Henderson State University in the 95th Battle of the Ravine. Ouachita rallied to erase a late 14-point deficit to beat the Reddies 40-37. TJ Cole scored the game-winning touchdown in overtime. This weekend, the Ouachita football team will face off against Northwest Missouri. They are the second-place team from the Mid-America Intercollegiate Athletic Association. They have a record of 9-2 with straight wins to end the regular season. This will be the first ever matchup between Ouachita and Northwest Missouri. This will be Ouachita's first playoff appearance since 2019. So, good luck and go Tigers! In wrestling, Ouachita came away with a 3-bracket win on Saturday at the Carl Albert State Collegiate Viking Open. Now Noah Yemens in the 125 bracket, James Anderson in the 133 bracket, and Johnny Green in the 285 bracket, all three came away as winners. Brooks finished in third in the 197 bracket. Jalen Otero made it into the semifinals in the 157 bracket. And Donald Paul lost in the semis to Johnny Green, his teammate. The Tigers will be back in action next Saturday for their first home match of the season, taking on Central Baptist. In men's basketball, the Tigers opened its regular season 72-57 with a win over the Arkansas Baptist College Buffaloes. The first half was back and forth, and Ouachita maintained a slim lead, but Arkansas Baptist stayed in the fight, keeping the Tigers' lead to a max of 5 points. The Tigers came back in the second half and opened on an 11-2 run. Tyler Haynes led the Tigers that night, securing almost double-double with 18 points on 8 of 9 shooting and 9 rebounds. As a team, the Tigers shot 46.3% from the field, including 59.4% second half, outshooting Arkansas Baptist College. So congratulations to the men's basketball team on that home opener win. That's all for the Roar Rundown this week. Be sure to watch Ouachita Athletics on the Ouachita Sports Digital Network. I'm Caroline Derby. Back to you.
Thank you, Caroline. The Department of Theater Arts will present The Servant of Two Masters. The show will run Thursday, November 17th through Saturday, November 20th at 7:30 p.m. There is also a matinee performance on Sunday, November 20th at 2:30 p.m. Tickets are $10 each and may be purchased on the box office website. Also, good news, this is an arts engagement event, so be sure to see a great show and get your credit. On Friday, the women of KaimU will be hosting a 2000s party and costume contest in the Tiger Den from 8:30 p.m. to 10:30 p.m. Come dressed like your younger selves.
That 2000s party sounds like fun. I think I'll have to break out my old silly bands.
Yes, I'll have to get some items together for it. I have plenty at home.
Well, that's all for this week. Happy Thanksgiving.
Yes, happy Thanksgiving. Be safe, and we will see you next time.
Hello, I'm Taylor King. I've been practicing law for over 34 years, but long before that, I learned what it takes to be a good lawyer. Caring for others. You could say it's a family trait, and it's one I've passed along to my kids. If you've been involved in an accident, call 1-800-CAR-WRECK. I want to help.
We want to help, to be on your side, by your side. I'm Austin King. Now, I've not been practicing law quite as long as my dad, but thanks to him, I know what it takes to be a good lawyer. I guess you could say it runs in the family.
I've heard people say Ouachita.
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 Is it pronounced Ouachita?
Searching for Ouachita Baptist University.
Back in Texas, everybody pronounces it Wichita, but really, it's Ouachita.
Ouachita. Ouachita.
How would you pronounce it?
Ouachita.
Ouachita.
It's Ouachita Baptist University. Get it right.
It's Ouachita, people. It's Ouachita.
Ouachita.
This is Joe Couch. Thank you for watching the Ouachita Sports Digital Network.
Our town, a place for new beginnings, stalwart pine trees, reuniting with old friends. Whether you find yourself here for a ball game, a wedding, or just to catch up with those you love, we want to invite you to be a guest on our front porch, a place to sit back and watch the world go by, a place where time seems to slow down. Our home away from home. Welcome back. Captain Henderson House, now accepting reservations.
Start your holiday season at Ouachita Baptist University's 30th annual Festival of Christmas. With new music, classic favorites, fun characters, and stirring moments, there is something magical for everyone. Whether it's your 13th time or your first, you do not want to miss this exciting tradition December 2nd and 3rd. Join us for Festival of Christmas. Tickets are on sale now at obu.edu/boxoffice.
Whether you realize it or not, you see the work of vets and signs all around Arkadelphia. When you see the Badger equipment trailer on the way to a Badger game, vets and signs did that. When you're watching the Badgers, Tigers, or Reddies and see the signage that just really makes their facilities pop, vets and signs did that too. You see the signage in downtown Arkadelphia, on the campuses of Ouachita and Henderson, or the sign in your neighbor's yard supporting a candidate or their favorite Badger? Yep, Bats and Sign did that too. Longtime residents and supporters of all things Arkadelphia, called Mark, Jared, Chris, or Ryan at Bats and Signs today to see what they can do for you. Thank you.
kick, trying to get there. It is good!
Received by White. His communication, and Tigers win!
And they're going to send around Allen. Is it going to be an inside the Parker? Yes, it is!
Court to the three-point line. Thornton underneath to Van Zandt. Layup at the buzzer. It's good. It's good. Ouachita storms the court.
Now managed by the Van Dorn Group, Sonic of Arkadelphia is ready to get involved in the Arkadelphia community. With the goal of making improvements to the Arkadelphia restaurant, the Van Dorn Group is committed to making Sonic of Arkadelphia one of the best around. Stop by Sonic of Arkadelphia today for a Route 44 slush or drink to go with the great Sonic burgers, tater tots, or french fries. Top it off with your favorite ice cream treat. Visit Sonic of Arkadelphia on 10th Street today.
If you or a loved one gets hurt in an accident, you need true care and concern. You can hand us everything, the bills, the paperwork, and anything else you need help with,
so you can focus on recovering from your injury.
That's why people turn to the Taylor King Law Firm.
You need an attorney with integrity and experience in dealing with the complex details.
We do everything we can to relieve the stress and take care of your family.
If you're injured in an accident, call 1-800-CAR-WRECK.
We'll be on your side, by your side.
Make Print Mania in downtown Arkadelphia your place to get embroidery, screen printing, trophies, and more. Drop by their store on Main Street in downtown Arkadelphia or visit their website at printmaniatees.com to see how they can help your business or group. Need a shirt for an event? Let Print Mania take care of that. Need promotional materials for your business or organization? You can let Print Mania take care of that too. A family-run local business in Arkadelphia, Print Mania has been serving the public since 1992. Call Print Mania today, 870-246-3803.
Visit the Ouachita Campus Store for all your Tiger apparel, merchandise, and gifts. If you need something to wear to show your Tiger pride, stop by the Ouachita Campus Store on the bottom floor of the Evans Student Center to grab a t-shirt, sweatshirt, polo, or more. If you can't stop by the store on campus, visit us online at bookstore.obu.edu. Make your purchase and we'll send it to you. Support the Tigers by checking out the Ouachita Campus Store. Go Tigers.
A new player has entered the game, Legacy Termite and Pest Control. While they may be a relatively new business, the owners and management team have decades of experience in the industry, and each know the key to success is customer focus. Legacy Termite and Pest Control wants you to make them your team, so they're offering a free evaluation that could save you thousands of dollars down the road. Call them right now, 501-251-6792. Legacy Termite and Pest Control, a proud supporter of the Ouachita Tigers.
What if wealth building wasn't just for the wealthy? And what if a bank set out to build a more financially inclusive world by helping 10,000 people achieve home ownership, supporting the creation and retention of 100,000 jobs, and empowering 1 million savers? Well, that would be a different kind of bank. That would be Southern Bancorp. Join the change at banksouthern.com/what if. Southern Bancorp.
This afternoon for the Rangers of Northwestern Oklahoma. Clarkson, straight drop, now forced out of the pocket. In trouble, sack! There it finally is. We've been waiting on that sack, and it is big Rovell Carter.
Well, how the you know, he's been getting away from a lot of them. That time, Rovell Carter doesn't get his arms on him. He just kind of wraps him up and lays down on top of him. You're not getting away that time.
The first half, Hayden Mallory scales behind him. Mallory's going to pass, got time, go into the end zone, intercepted! It goes back to Ouachita! Coming up with it, Hayden Laster, the senior, out of Warren.
Laster with the interception in the end zone, and he played that one perfectly.
Hayden Lassiter, the senior out of Warren, is his holder. Here we go. Snap. Hold. Kick. Trying to get there. It is good! It's good! It's good!
Oh, don't you love this celebration on the Ouachita side? Everybody with their hands in the air saying it is good. Gabe Goodman from Arkadelphia nailed it.
There's Edwards back, and there he may go! 45-50, 45-40, 35-30, 25-20, 15-10, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Promised land, touchdown. He just went all the way. He went 72 yards. Second down, 10 yards needed for a first down. Now Connor Flanagan goes in motion right to left. Out of the shotgun, called quarterback keeper, running room, 30, 25, 20. Zaylin Falls, Justin Dean deep for Ouachita. After 21 months away, Ouachita football is back. Falls at the 6, cuts over to the 10, the 15, the 20, the 25, the 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, 45, 40. Hits the far sideline to the 30. He's to the 20. He's to the 10. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Promised land. No flags down. Touchdown, Ouachita. Kendall Gibbons right up the middle. First down, Ouachita. He's going, he's going, he's still going, he's going to the promised land. It's Kendall Gibbons, it's a touchdown, Ouachita. Other side, that's the wide side of the field protect this time. He looks this way, can't find anybody. Sack! Back at the 29-yard line, it was Damian McDonald. Going to be the direct snap to T.J. Cole. Isaac Edwards set to his left. Cole looking up the middle of the field, finds running room as he cuts back right. He's going to be to the 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Promised land. No flags down. Touchdown, T.J. Cole. Touchdown, Ouachita.
Well, he just got around that edge, Rex, and once he got to that edge, you knew he was going.
Tigers trailing 21 to nothing, but with a 2nd and 7 now with their deepest penetration so far at the 33. T.J. Cole, good running room, gets away at the 20, the 15, 10, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, promised land. Touchdown, T.J. Cole. The Tigers are finally on the board. They sent on the near hash mark. They are going to pass. Looking, Morse has time. It's batted in the air, and it's intercepted. It is intercepted by Ouachita, coming up with it on the first possession, Terrell Gibson. Touchdown, Ouachita.
Playoff at the buzzer. Is it going to be an inside the Parker? Yes, it is.
Northwest Missouri State momentarily to begin the second half at halftime. It's Northwest 23, Ouachita 3, and we'll go to the voice of the Tigers, Rex Nelson.
And Northwest Missouri State gets the football to start this second half so they can add to what is already a 20-point lead. It has been all Bearcats so far. Boy, what a program. Six national titles through the years. They are 52-19 school history in the playoffs. Here is the kick by Dax Jaggers. He'll be down to in the end zone. I want to read some other things here. This is their 18th consecutive playoff season. They've had 26 overall when they've made the playoffs. So 52 playoff victories in school history. Ouachita has, Richard, one playoff victory in school history.
Well, a little bit of a difference there. We knew this was a good team, and they're showing it so far. They showed it in the first half. Ouachita, I mean, to stay in this one, got to get a stop here on defense and put some points on the board really quick. And they have not looked good on offense, and the defense in the second quarter really got worn down.
Yeah, this traditionally, Northwest has been the gold standard of Division II. Moya on the first play will get the handoff and go out to the 28-yard line where Dante Gibson comes up for Ouachita. Gain of three, second down and seven from the 28 for the Bearcats.
Moya did a good job just kind of getting in the hole, holding up for a minute and picking a little bit. There wasn't a whole lot there, but just did a nice enough picking to get those few yards there on first down. I imagine they keep it on the ground on second down.
Four down linemen for Ouachita. They do keep it on the ground. Moya turning the corner at the 30. Cuts back in for the first down. But a late flag in, Jeff, and I think this one's going to come back. It's holding.
He made a nice cut, but he had room to make that cut because of a holding call on the far side. That's going to help out the Tigers. Very important, Rex, that Ouachita hold Northwest here and try to get back in the game with their first drive. Very, very important every play on this drive.
Yeah, that hold was on the receiver out there right as Moya tried to cut up the field. And it was one of those pretty obvious ones. I think Northwest knew that right off the bat. And Washington's got them in some second and longs and third and longs today, Rex. They haven't been able to get it off the field. That's been the difference in this game is Northwest's ability to convert on third down and Washington's inability to convert on third down. 6 of 8 compared to 0 of 7.
Yep. Big difference right there. Second and 12 from the 23 after the penalty is marked off. A wide out to either side for Hohensee now as he comes out of the shotgun. Going to give on the ground again, however, looking for running room and not finding much that time, Jeff, was Jaden Brady, and it's going to be third and long.
Good work by a couple of defensive linemen. Josiah Johnson also in there, and it is third down and long, and now an opportunity to turn those stats around in the second half.
Boy, this is where the trouble's been, though, Richard. Third and long.
It has. We'll see. And Ouachita in the first half on all the third downs, I think they brought pressure once, maybe twice. We're sitting back in coverage. We'll see if maybe they change some things up at halftime to adjust to that because the zone coverage, the Bearcats were picking them apart across the middle.
Hohensee, three down linemen rushing for Ouachita. They need to get some pressure on him here on third down and 10. An empty backfield with trips to the left side. Two men to the right side. Straight drop back. Throw down the middle of the field. Caught down at the Ouachita 40. And nothing has changed since the first half. Has it, Jeff? Coming up with it, Cole Hembro, the 6'3 tight end.
He's 6'3. He's big. He was covered up by Andrew Hayes, but there was just no way to stop it. A beautiful pass. Good catch. He had size on the defender, and he made the catch.
Yeah, Ouachita cannot stop this team on third and long. Well, it's that simple.
That was a perfect pass, and Hayes, just so much smaller, was basically boxed out like a defender, and like in basketball, never had a chance to get around the much bigger tight end to make a play on the ball.
So here come the Bearcats again. They are passing out into the left flats. Got a receiver in space at the 35, at the 30, at the 25, all the way down to the Ouachita 20-yard line, and just like that, there to the red zone, it is Kashawn Griffin.
Yeah, Ouachita needs to force a turnover. That's back to the short pass. Very rare for them to go for a deep pass on third down. They did it there, but then back to just a short, quick little wide receiver screen, get their athletes in space there on first down and get another first down, and they're right at the red zone.
Yeah, this one's about to get very ugly, I'm afraid. First down and 10, ball at the 20-yard line. Northwest already leading 23-3, threatening to add more now here in the third quarter. Here is the give on the ground, turning the corner at the 15, at the 10, all the way down to the 7-yard line, and Ouachita can do nothing about it. That was Jaden Brady again, Jeff.
Really good blocking by the receivers all day long for Northwest. They're good receivers, but they have learned to block well, and that opened up some space in the secondary once he hit the sideline and then cut it up, made a nice run. This is looking like a dominant offense right now, isn't it?
Definitely. Just dominating Ouachita. That was a 14-yard gain on that play. Now Moya back in as the running back. Give to Moya, coming left. Gets away from one Tiger, gets away from a second, but not a third, down at the 5-yard line. Gain of one, first down and goal from the 5. But, boy, there's just kind of a feeling, to be honest with you, Richard, that the dike is really breaking. The little boy's finger's been in it a long time. It's really breaking now.
Yeah, Northwest having some success, and most of the runs they've had success. They saw what Henderson did last week. They were running off tackle, and that's where they've had a lot of the success so far today. Ouachita's allowed a few up the middle, but not too many. It's those outside runs that are hurting.
Hoensy with Moya set to his right. He fakes to Moya, going to pass. Rolling right, throwing into the end zone, caught. Easy touchdown. Northwest Missouri State bringing it in for the Bearcats, Kashawn Griffin.
That's just an easy route out there. It's
made it look very easy.
Go dig inside and then tuck outside, and of course the quarterback's rolling that way, and it's tough for the defender to cover, and he was there with them but unable to get in front, and
Cole
that's an
Lammel.
Easy touchdown.
Cole Lammel on to attempt the extra point. 10:41 still left in the third quarter. This would make it 30-3 in favor of Northwest Missouri. Snap, hold, kick, it is good. Northwest Missouri State 30, Ouachita 3. NCAA Division II playoff action presented by Visit Hot Springs continues from Cliff Harris Stadium in Arkadelphia in 30 seconds here on the Ouachita Football Network.
Hello, I'm Taylor King. I've been practicing law for over 34 years, but long before that, I learned what it takes to be a good lawyer. Caring for others. You could say it's a family trait, and it's one I've passed along to my kids. If you've been involved in an accident, call 1-800-CAR-WRECK. I want to help.
We want to help, to be on your side, by your side. I'm Austin King. Now, I've not been practicing law quite as long as my dad, but thanks to him, I know what it takes to be a good lawyer. I guess you could say it runs in the family.
West 30, Ouachita 3 after a 7-play, 75-yard drive to begin the second half. Northwest in control.
Very much in control. Like I said, they have won more national championships than any other team in Division II. They've won 6 of them through the years. They've had more playoff seasons, 26 overall, including 18 straight, than anybody else. Here is the kick. Going to be taken at the 11-yard line. It was fair caught. And so the Ouachita offense will come back on for the first time in the second half, Richard. And we'll see if they made any adjustments at halftime as they were unable to score a touchdown in the first half of play.
Well, the run game didn't work in the first half at all.
Not at all.
They didn't really have much chance to go to it because it was so many three and outs there. They got some yards on passing the football down the field on that last drive. We'll see if maybe they do that. But I think they'll probably stick with T.J. Cole a little bit, but they got to start hitting some intermediate passing routes here. The deep ball's not working, but they got to hit some intermediate passes to get some stuff going down the field.
First down and 10 from the 25. They set on the near hash mark. Riley Harms gives to T.J. Cole. 1 yard is all. Second and 9.
And right now, the Bearcats aren't worried about the pass at all. I mean, they've got a good enough front 7, but when you allow them to put 8, possibly 9 looking in the box at a run, just because they're not worried about the pass at all, it's tough to stop. The safeties aren't playing right at the line of scrimmage. They're coming downhill quick, though, Rex.
Yeah, they really are. Second down and 9 from the 26. Cole has just been unable to hit those short passes we were talking about before the game in order to loosen them up. Here he tries one across the middle at the 30, but that's only going to gain, Jeff, 4 yards and still leave you with a 3rd and 5.
Well, they got a completion. No yardage after the catch, though, as he went down immediately. And so Ouachita will have to convert on a third down, something they had major trouble with in the first half.
Yeah, they didn't convert on any, did they, Richard? You said?
No, yeah. They didn't. And the difference is, all year, Ouachita's been able to line up and not have to be creative sometimes and say, well, you know what's coming, but we're going to beat you at it against this Bearcat team. You can't do that quite as much.
0 for 7 on third down in the game thus far. And they face a third and 5 here at their 30. Harms, pass, finally got a conversion out over the 40 to the 41-yard line. Connor Flanagan, an 11-yard gain on third and 5. First third down conversion of the afternoon, Richard.
It is, and not surprised at all to see Flanagan get it. Of course, they had one converted earlier, but penalty took it back. And they're going to have to, if they want to climb back in this one, first of all, they're going to make some stops on defense, but they got to get Flanagan the ball some. And
yep.
He's been very good on some double moves. If he hits some of those short ones, then all of a sudden a double move deep, maybe they can release him.
First down and 10, ball at the 40-yard line. Ouachita working left to right. They trail Northwest Missouri 30-3 in the third quarter. Harms going deep. He's got Flanagan down there, and Flanagan was pushed, and no flag was thrown.
That's terrible.
Yeah, I agree.
He was pushed down. He was pushed down, and I let him do some hand fighting, but he was pushed down right in front of the official, and that's terrible.
That one, that really was that time.
He had him beat. He was, the ball was coming. I mean, that's.
I don't know how you miss that. Todd Knight's in the ear.
They say they let him play
the official
in the playoffs.
Well, you
I
can't
don't
let him push people
that,
down,
though.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm in agreement there. That was really bad.
It wasn't a hard push, but when he's stopping playing the football, it doesn't take much.
Second down and 10. Harms looking to pass. Got time. Now he's forced out of the pocket. Now he's in trouble and has to throw it away. And suddenly again, Jeff, you're faced with third and long.
Third down and long. Harms with a lot of time to throw that time. Offensive line did a nice job, but just nobody open. He continued to backpedal until he finally had to give it up and throw it out of bounds.
Third down and 10, ball at the 41-yard line. Ouachita trying to get something going on offense. They trail 30-3 with 8:40 left to go in the third quarter. Trips to the left side, one man to the right side on third and 10. Riley Harms with T.J. Cole set to his right. Harms sets up in trouble, sacked. They'll punt it again. Sacked back at the 34-yard line. That's a loss of another 7. Fourth down and 17 for Ouachita. And Joe Couch will come on and punt for the Tigers. Couch in the first half had 3 punts. He averaged 36.3 yards per punt.
And the Bearcats brought a blitz that time. Cahill Smith, the defensive back, came from the front side. But Harms never saw him coming. If he had seen it coming, he could have gotten it out to, I think it was Swoboda who was open over there where the blitz came. But he was looking on the other side of the field, and Smith, easy sack there.
So already leading 30-3, Northwest will get the football back. Takes a good Ouachita bounce. Another good Couch punt. Inside the 20, will be down to the 19-yard line. First down and 10, Northwest Missouri. Bearcats will work from there. 19-yard line, leading 30-3 with 7:51 left in the third quarter of this NCAA playoff game from Cliff Harris Stadium in Arkadelphia. I don't think I've ever seen totally cloudy skies turn into almost totally clear skies as they did today. We needed the lights early, and it looks kind of strange having them on now, Jeff, with the lights on.
It does indeed. It's turned into a bright, sunny day. Still a cool day. Good crowd turned out for this. They just haven't had a lot to cheer about here on the Ouachita side.
Four down linemen rushing for Ouachita on first down. Give over right guard. That's going to be Jay Harris. Harris over the 20 to the 21. Gain of only 2 on the play. Second down and 8 from the 21 for Northwest Missouri.
Ouachita still doing a decent job bottling those runs up in the middle, but Northwest has had good success on the outside. They obviously took what they learned from Ouachita the last couple weeks. Has had a little bit of trouble, especially last week against the Reddies on those outside runs. Didn't hurt them last week because they were able to get the win. Today's been hurting them some, but I think they're going to be throwing here possibly on second down.
Second down and 8, Hohensee. Out of the shotgun, one man set to his right, fakes to him, is going to pass, sets up, goes deep, got an open receiver, caught at the 40, at the 35, all the way down to the Ouachita 27-yard line. They burned the Tigers and burned them deep. Once again, Kashawn Griffin, Jeff.
plenty of time to throw the ball. Griffin had time to get downfield to get by himself. He beat the freshman, was able to get downfield. Steven Weston got there for the tackle.
Ouachita's been seeing those short passes and those runs, and we're creeping up a little bit. The Bearcats saw that and took the easy shot down the field.
They'll mark it at the 25-yard line. First down and 10. Northwest trying to add to a 30-3 lead with 6:45 left to go in the third quarter of play. Moya, the running back, he gets the pitch. Coming right, good running room there. Inside the 20-19, and just like that, they're in the red zone with a gain of 6, second and 4 from the 19-yard line of Ouachita.
I think he might have actually gotten tackled by his own players. Jacoby Nolan was pushing an offensive lineman. I think right as he went to cut, he hit the leg of that offensive lineman because he was upset. He thought he was going to have more. Nolan just pushed the lineman into the right spot there.
Two wide receivers to the near side this time on second and 4 from the Ouachita 19-yard line. Hohensee gives big hole again. Moya inside the 15 to the 13. Gain of another 6 and another first down. Northwest Missouri will go to the number one team in the country next week to play Grand Valley State. But, boy, the way they're looking today, I think that may be a heck of a ball game, Jeff.
I would agree. That is an outstanding team from Michigan. They're going to make the trip up there. They're going to have their hands full, but they are primed and ready for that contest.
Well, they're used to being in national championship games. They lost two early in the season. But they have put it together late in the season, and this really has the look of a team that could win a national championship. Hohensee, wide open receiver, going to be an easy touchdown, taking it in for Northwest Missouri as they have completely blown this thing open now, is the tight end, Cole Hembrough.
Yeah, just wide open across the middle of the field that time, and Washtenaw's watching the receivers, nobody seeing Hembrough go across, and he's able to walk in for his easiest touchdown he's probably had this year.
Well, it's really a shame. I mean, Ouachita just seems out of energy after that comeback against Henderson. It was such a magical season, but it's turned embarrassing here in the playoffs today, and a shame. But nothing to take away. We'll talk about later about what a great season this has been. Still time left in this one as the extra point's good. It's Northwest Missouri State 37, Ouachita 3, 5:22 left in the third quarter. Ouachita football 2022, presented by Visit Hot Springs, continues from Cliff Harris Stadium in Arkadelphia in 30 seconds here on the Ouachita Football Network.
I'm Nicole Auerbach from The Athletic.
Hey, this is Alex Pruitt with Sports Illustrated Magazine.
This is Kevin Kugler of Westwood One.
Hi, everybody. It's Pete Kranick of the Memphis Grizzlies and Fox Sports Southeast.
This is Danielle Musselman.
This is Kyle Peterson with ESPN.
This is Tom Hart of ESPN and the SEC Network. Thanks for tuning in to the Ouachita Sports Digital Network.
Five. 22 seconds left in the third quarter, and Northwest has come on strong here in the third to stretch its lead out to 34 points. It is Northwest 37, Ouachita 3.
I call them the Alabama of Division II, and they're kind of like I said, had a couple losses early, but some of the Alabama teams we've seen in the past would have a regular season loss and then come on and win a national championship. And this kind of fully strikes me with their tradition of a team that could win a national championship, Richard, despite two regular season losses early.
Well, if they come out of this region, they have an excellent chance. This region is the
it's loaded.
Is the toughest region by far in D2.
Here is Zaylin Falls. He gets away from one man, gets away from a second. Decent return out over the 30-yard line. They'll mark it actually right on the 30. So first down and 10, 30-yard line. Would love to see T.J. Cole just get something going in what now is obviously his last game as a Ouachita Tiger. Boy, he has been fun to watch these last 4 years, Jeff. I can't say enough about T.J. Cole from Pleasant Grove, Texas.
It's just been fantastic. And to see him come on so strong the last couple of years as the leader of the team in more than one way, it's been great.
Got Kendall Gibbons in there now. They're passing out into the flats. Justin Dean out over the 30, forced out of bounds on the near sideline. That's the Ouachita sideline at the 38. That's a gain of 8, Richard, second down and 2.
Yeah, good job that time. I like the little bit of a roll they had there. And then Dean just creates a good target. and gets a nice catch there. Dean, of course, had a huge week last week against the Reddies. Been held pretty quiet so far today.
Second down and two, ball at the 38-yard line. Tigers set on the near hash mark. Come out of the pistol. There is the give to Kendall Givens. Givens goes over the 40, out to the 43. That is a gain of another 5 yards and a first down to Ouachita. Working from the 43, clock running, 4.5 minutes left, third quarter. Ouachita trailing 37-3.
First down in this situation a minute ago is when they tried the deep shot to Flanagan, didn't get it. See if they keep it on the ground here, maybe try and get something going and see if they can get a touchdown here.
Tigers moving left to right in this third quarter. They set on the near hash mark. Givens, the sophomore, set behind quarterback Riley Harms. Justin Dean goes in motion left to right. Give to Givens. Givens, nothing there that time. Give him a yard. It's more like a half yard, and it'll be second down and 9 from the 44-yard line.
Elijah Green and Jake Foster in there on the tackle. Foster, the defensive end, did a good job crashing down. 6'5", 253-pound defensive end, did a good job crashing down and keeping Givens from being able to cut back, and he got him down around the waist. Then Green kind of came in and cleaned him up.
On second down and 9, they're going to have Harms passing right across the middle of the field. Too hard, intercepted at the 50. Brought back to the Ouachita 40. Back to the 30-yard line. All the way down to the Ouachita 29-yard line. And things just keep going south for Ouachita.
Yeah, Dean went high to catch that one, hit the referee. The referee hit him in the side as he went to catch it, and that ball was hot anyway. It was going to be a tough catch, and went through his arms, and he ends up landing on the referee. Good to see the umpire's up and okay. So he got hit pretty good on that one.
Here comes Northwest Missouri again. First down and 10, working from the Ouachita 29 with a 37-3 lead and 3:24 left in the third quarter. Mike Owensy will stay in there at quarterback. They'll go out of the pistol this time with Moya set behind him. There is the give to Moya over right guard. Going to be a loss of one that time. Good job by Ouachita's Ty Compton, the senior out of Sylvan Hills, to make the tackle. A number of Tigers. It's now evident that they're playing their last game. Ty Compton, one of them, Jeff.
Ty Compton, what a career at Ouachita. Done a super job as a linebacker, quick linebacker, puts pressure on the quarterback, a good tackler, third leading tackler on the team this year. Really done a fine job in his career.
Second down and 14, ball at the 33-yard line. It is going to be a pass. Got a wide open receiver again. He's going to go to the 10, down to the 5, down to the Ouachita 4-yard line. It's going to be first down and goal. It said same man again who scored the last touchdown, Cole Hembrough. They just can't stop him, Richard.
Yeah, they're going to the big tight end. Only 20 catches on the year. That's his, I think, fourth so far today.
I'll say he may have 20 before this game's over. They'll mark it at the 6, actually, so it's going to be first down and goal from the 6-yard line of Ouachita. They're about to go over 40 points in the ball game. 2.5 minutes left in the third quarter. Owensy with Harris now as his running back. Harris set to his right. Harris gets the give and gets about a yard before the tackle's made by Matthew Burton, a freshman out of Longview.
That's going to come back. I think there's a illegal procedure on the Bearcats.
Burton has played a lot this year as a freshman.
And
yep, legal formation, 5-yard penalty. So it'll be
first and goal from the 11. And so Burton, I was mentioning a freshman. This is, if you look at it, Richard, even though they went 11-0 in the regular season, a relatively young Tiger football team.
Well, they lose T.J. Cole, and they lose a lot on the offensive line. But they return a lot at receiver. They return Riley Harms. They return a lot on defense.
A lot on defense.
You're looking
yeah.
out there. Sometimes you got two freshman corners out there. I mean, a lot on defense.
First down and goal from the 11. Owensy with Moya set to his left, and Moya that time fell forward. It's like he started his forward motion. He just couldn't stop. Richard, another 5.
That's the easiest false start you're going to call when the running back just falls over.
Yeah, he just kind of fell forward, Jeff.
He did. Slipped a little bit there. And it's first and goal, but they're backing up.
Yeah, first and goal from the 16. If you're Ouachita, you'll take whatever you can get at this point. Northwest trying to add to a 37-3 lead with a minute 53 left in the third quarter. ONC is going to pass. Can't find anybody open. Going to run. Got lots of grass in front of him. Now a good open field tackle made. Thought he was going to get more than he did, but it was a nice open field tackle by Jackson Miller. But we've got a hold, so we'll back them up again, Jeff.
That quarterback keeper was a good play, but helped out by a holding call by an offensive lineman, and so they're going to back him up.
Yeah, they called the hold on the right guard, and it was right as ONC went right by him, and the defensive lineman tried to get off of him. The right guard just held on and wouldn't let him get off, and so it was right in front of the referee there.
Gentlemen, it's still first and goal after three straight penalties. Just first and goal from the 26 instead of the 6.
Well, that's been the one chink in the armor for the Bearcats. They, you know, this is the playoffs, and they let them play, so they let them get away with a lot, but the Bearcats have still had a lot of penalties despite that today.
First and goal from the 26 of Ouachita. Moya as the running back set to the right of ONC. ONC straight drop back, looking, under pressure, gets it down there into the end zone, dropped. Intended receiver on the play, Jamar Moya, and probably should have had the catch. It was a good pass, Richard.
Well, Jax Miller was running right with him, didn't turn around for the ball, otherwise he probably could have picked it, but was right in front of him and had his hands up, so Moya may not have had a clear look at that one. It's going to be just now, Rex, second down after all this.
Yeah, second down and goal from the 26. Minute 16 left in the third quarter.
Little surprised to still see ONC out there maybe this point. And really all the starters for the Bearcats.
Seeing they've got Grand Valley coming up in Michigan next week.
Would expect them maybe in the fourth not to be out there, but.
Second down, goal to go. Northwest Missouri State set at the near hash mark, moving right to left. And what's our discussion about holding things up?
They're having a discussion with head coach Rich Wright over there. I don't know about what. They said an injury timeout. So maybe somebody on the sidelines we couldn't see. It was close enough to affect play. We couldn't tell who that was.
Rich Wright's been head coach since 2017. He's going to go to 4-1 in the first round as a head coach. He hadn't won a national title, but he was on the staff there, Jeff, for 4 national championships. So he's part of that winning tradition.
He certainly is. Now they're going to put the ball back into play. One of the officials checking on another official.
It's the umpire that got hit on that when Justin Dean, when he basically hit Justin Dean on that pass across the middle a little while ago. I think he was getting more worse for wear because he's out of the ball game now.
So we're having to switch officials. That's what the timeout was about. Second down and goal from the 26. Hohensee's going to pass. Goes left side. Got a receiver at the 25. Nowhere to go. Good tackle that time by Ouachita's Jax Miller. And it's going to bring up third and goal from the 25 of Ouachita.
They've run that kind of screen across the middle several times. I think that's the one thing Ouachita has really done a good job defending. They haven't allowed anything really on that one.
It's when they're most dangerous, though, Jeff. Third and a long way to go.
They've been dangerous on third and anything so far.
Haven't
today.
They? Boy, they have just been deadly on third down, Northwest Missouri. We've been very impressed today. ONC straight drop back. Got some time. Passes across the middle. Incomplete. Almost intercepted. And let's see if they try a long field goal here.
Jax Miller knocked it away. Dawson Miller was diving
for it. The other Miller almost got it. Yeah, Jax knocked it away. Dawson Miller, the junior from Heath, Texas, almost got it and couldn't hang on. So they will try the field goal now to have 40 points even on the board. Going to be a 42-yard attempt from the near hash mark for Cole Lammel. Lammel from 42 late in the third quarter of play. Snap, hold, his kick, trying to get there, and it is good. And the lead is 40-3.
It was good by about a yard, but it was good.
Well, it's one of those days. I told you, everything's gone right for Northwest. Everything's gone wrong for Ouachita. It's Northwest Missouri State 40, Ouachita Baptist University 3, just past the top of the hour. Let's pause for station identification on this, the Ouachita Football Network.
I'm Nicole Auerbach from The Athletic.
Hey, this is Alex Pruitt with Sports Illustrated Magazine.
This is Kevin Kugler of Westwood One.
Hi, everybody. It's Pete Kranick of the Memphis Grizzlies and Fox Sports Southeast.
This is Danielle Musselman.
This is Kyle Peterson with ESPN.
This is Tom Hart of ESPN and the SEC Network. Thanks for tuning in to the Ouachita Sports Digital Network.
Drive, six plays, ended in a 42-yard field goal that was good, and it's Northwest 41 or 40 to Ouachita's 3. 26 seconds left, third quarter.
So late in the third quarter, we'll see if Ouachita can get anything going on offense. Have yet to score a touchdown this afternoon in NCAA playoff action against this fine Northwest Missouri team. Here is the kick. Going to be taken at the 12, brought across the field by Zaylin Falls. His helmet comes off, but he hangs on to the football out over the 30, out to the 32-yard line. So with 17 seconds left in the third quarter, it'll be first down and 10. Ouachita working from its 32-yard line.
Cole's going to be out there running back as Givens was on the last drive a little bit. And like to see them maybe try and pass the ball to T.J. Cole. Just get him the ball in space.
Yeah.
He's been open about three or four times coming out of the backfield, but that's not where they're looking.
I would like him to see him finish this All-American career strong. He is going to pass, but Riley Harms just mowed down for a sack that time. Hit really hard by Jake Fisher, the defensive end. Nobody touched him coming in, Jeff.
Nobody at all. Harms had no chance to get rid of the football.
The mental clock for the quarterback's got to be about double, about twice as fast so far today.
Into the third quarter, it's all Northwest. Northwest Missouri State 40, Ouachita 3. Ouachita Football 2022 presented by Visidot Springs continues with fourth quarter play-by-play in 60 seconds here on the Ouachita Football Network. Second and 16, Riley Harms likely will be passing. Looks to his left, has a receiver at the 30 going out of bounds. Connor Flanagan, they'll give him to the 31. That's only 5 yards, bringing up third and 11. End of three quarters, Northwest has 21 first downs. Ouachita has 9. Northwest has 114 rushing yards. Ouachita has just 7. Passing 322 to 80. In total domination today for Northwest Missouri State. Third and 11 from the 31-yard line as the ball set on the near hash mark. Harms sets up again, having to leave the pocket. Now he goes downfield in a crowd caught by Connor Flanagan. You said no, caught this time by Tucker Swoboda. In a crowd, too, Richard.
Well, Ouachita's got good receivers with hands. Sometimes you just got to throw it up and let them make a play. And he went up and made that play. And I don't know if Harms was throwing to him or Flanagan or just hoping one of them would get there. And Harms going to check out of the ballgame. Ouachita's going to go with a direct snap with T.J. Cole. I would not be shocked to see him pass the football here at all.
I wouldn't be at all. Down to the 29 now of Northwest Missouri State. from the 29. The All-American T.J. Cole will take the direct snap. Isaac Edwards setting to his right. He is throwing. He's got a wide-open receiver and couldn't get it to him. Oh, my. Jeff, he had Justin Dean.
Yeah, he could have lofted that ball. He threw it a little bit on the line. Beautiful spiral, but it went out in front of the receiver. Incomplete. Love the play call.
Now, TJ's upset. I'm watching him. He's hitting his own helmet, Richard.
He wanted that. That would have been his third touchdown pass of the year. And you're right. He had it there. Just didn't loft it. Just threw too much on a line.
Yep, absolutely. First and ten, second 10. Now from the 29. On second and 10, Riley Harms will come back in. He'll throw to Cole. Cole turns the corner, goes inside the 20. He says, I'm going to make up for it partially. You saw some really strong second effort there. You can tell TJ was mad, and it's first down in the red zone at the 16.
Really good catch on the run. Got around the first defender, made a nice sidestep, and got extra yardage. That's good, Cole.
And that's been open a lot today.
Yeah, it
has. We'll see if they keep going to that here in the fourth quarter. I know it's not something Ouachita does. They've probably done that about five times all year. But we'll see if they maybe go back to that more in the fourth quarter until the Bearcats decide to start covering it. They've allowed him the release out of the backfield.
They have. First down and 10, ball at the 16. Direct snap to T.J. Cole. Cole trying to cut up the field, and he goes back inside and is only going to have a yard this time, second and 9 from the 15. Going gets tough now against a fine Northwest defense that is second in the nation, Jeff, coming into the game in rushing defense. We can see why.
You really can. I mean, it's one thing when Cole's got to dance around one player or run through one player, but when multiple guys are beating their blocks, you just can't get it going.
Second down and 9 from the 15, Northwest Missouri State in full control, 40-3, 12 and a half minutes left in this football game, but Ouachita trying to finally get a touchdown as they will go on the direct snap to T.J. Cole. He's going to run it this time. This time he's got a bit of a seam, not a big one, though, down to the 12, and you're back in a passing situation now, Richard, with third and 6.
I think it's four down territory, so I think you could still run the ball twice here if you want to, but Harm's going to come back in, and Cole's going to limp out. Actually, I think he's okay coming out. Givens is just going to come in. He's just taking his time getting off the field.
All right, Kendall Givens then is the running back, but I think they're passing here. Third down and 6, Ouachita set on the far hash mark, moving right to left, fourth quarter. Harms in trouble yet again. He's been running for his life all day. Lofts it into the end zone, and it's going to be incomplete, and that'll bring up fourth and 6, Jeff.
Harms probably needed to fire that one in there. He lofted it instead, and the defender was in time and got a hand on the football to knock it loose.
He hadn't had time all day, though, Richard.
Yeah, he hasn't. This is really, I mean, every now and then the Bearcats will bring pressure, but they're getting pressure with their front four or front maybe even five if they're bringing a linebacker, and that's hard to do. You got to have the quick hitters on offense, but at the same time, then you're only getting 3 or 4 yards at a time.
Yeah, they're just winning big time at the line of scrimmage. Fourth down and 6 from the 12, and we've got a timeout on the field.
The Bearcats were a little confused on defense there, it looked like.
11:46 left. Northwest Missouri State 40, Ouachita 3. Ouachita football 2022 continues from Cliff Harris Stadium in 30 seconds here on the Ouachita Football Network.
This is Joe Couch. Thank you for watching the Ouachita Sports Digital Network.
This is Terrell Gibson. Thanks for watching Ouachita Sports Digital Network.
This is Kendall Givens. Thanks for watching Ouachita Sports Digital Network.
And it's been a Bearcat day. Northwest 40, Ouachita 3. Tigers going for it on fourth down.
Fourth and 6, ball at the Bearcat 12-yard line. Tigers set in the middle of the field. They'll come out of the shotgun. Kendall Givens set to the left of his quarterback to block. Two wide receivers either side. Pass across the middle at the 5 down to the 3-yard line. That's enough for a first down.
That's a heck of a catch by Justin Dean and a really good throw by Harms on the slant. Dean drug a defender with him a little bit to get down there close. And That's the closest to the end zone the Tigers have been today. I think they'll probably try and keep it on the ground, but it's not going to be easy, even from the 3-yard line.
No, not against this run defense. First and goal from the 3. They will leave Harms in there. Kendall Givens, the running back. They're going to pass it. Now Harms gets away. He throws it too low, too hard. Kendall Givens, the intended receiver, Jeff. It'll be second and goal from the 3.
Tried to get it to Givens low where only Givens could get to it, but it bounced to Givens incomplete. Once again, he just had no time.
I think
had
it was
trouble.
A designed run because Givens was out there blocking.
Yeah.
It may have been a designed run and just kind of turned around the last second and the ball's there at his feet.
Yeah, he didn't go for the end zone, though. He backed up, fired it in the ground.
Second down and goal from the 3-yard line. Now they come out of the pistol. They're gonna split the quarterback out and go with the direct snap to Kendall Givens. Givens over right tackle, only a yard. Third down and goal from the 2. Doja's gonna get tough down here, Richard.
Well, I think you still on third and fourth down, just run it. That's been your bread and butter all year. Just run it, and if you don't get it in there, you got it backed up. But I'll let Kendall Givens have 2 other chances at it.
Yep, they're going to leave him in there. Kendall Givens, glad we get to see him a couple of more years. Great running back out of Little Rock Christian. He is just a sophomore. Givens set to the left of his quarterback on third and goal. They are going to pass, though. Pass, and the receiver slid down on his knees, and we got a flag down.
Well, he fell out of bounds and then came back in.
Tucker Swoboda.
It depends on if he was pushed out of bounds or not is what it depends on. But he was on his knees when he made the catch.
Yep. He had gone out of bounds, though. The official threw his hat down.
Depends on if he willingly went in or was forced out.
Yep.
Looked like
he was down on all 4s and then caught the ball as he
snapped it. Touchdown.
I was going to say, watching the replay, he never went out of bounds.
Touchdown, Ouachita.
They said he contacted out of bounds. It was never out of bounds. I hadn't heard that, but the replay looked like he was always in. Great catch by Swoboda. He made 2 big catches on that drive on the long, long pass on the to get the first down, and then that touchdown from his knees.
Well, very anticlimactic call since we had to wait so long before they said touchdown as Ouachita finally gets a touchdown in this football game. Gabe Goodman will kick the extra point up and good. 10:35 left in the game. Northwest Missouri State 40, Ouachita 10. Ouachita football 2022, presented by Bissett Hot Springs, continues in 30 seconds here on the Ouachita Football Network.
Northwest 40, Ouachita 10, 10:35 left in the football game.
Officials, though, ate a ham sandwich, 3 pickles, an olive, drank a Coke, and then finally called touchdown.
Yeah, we watched the replay of it. And
that's kind
of
how that went.
He was never really that close to out of bounds, and one of the officials was on it. The other just flat out missed it.
Yeah. They haven't had their best day either today. Here's the kick. It's going to be allowed to bounce, now picked up and out of bounds back inside the 20. Will be Northwest Missouri's Kashawn Griffin. And so 10:32 left in this one. Northwest Missouri is going to win. We'll see what they do on offense now with a 30-point lead and 10.5 minutes left.
Would expect to maybe Brendan Wright out there at quarterback.
Who's a great quarterback in his own right.
80-something touchdown, 87 career touchdowns.
Yeah, and he doesn't start. He's number 5 all-time in school history passing.
And he's got their beat backup out. Quarterback. Yeah.
And got beat out. He's in there now. I wouldn't think they'd be passing that much. They go to the ground here, and it's going to be a loss of yardage as a good tackle made by Anthony Freeman, the junior from Monroe Neville High School. just a junior again. That's another one that'll be coming back next year. We look forward to seeing in his senior season, Jeff.
Yeah, Anthony Freeman has been a key player for a number of years, but he's got one left, and he's going to use it. He plans to be back next year.
Second down and 12 from the 13-yard line for Northwest Missouri, and they're, of course, content to run this play clock down on every play. We're under 10 minutes now left in the football game, 9:53 and counting. Going on the ground, turning the corner, positive yardage this time, up over the 15 to the 17. That's a gain of 4, third down and 8 on the at the 17-yard line.
Just a complete caravan with him running out there, blockers. Yeah. I thought he was going to be able to get more because of that. Washington did a good job kind of breaking up that caravan and stopping him for not a huge gain. And third down, this is where Washington's had trouble getting off the field all day long.
Third down and 8, ball at the 17-yard line. They'll send trips to the near side as they are set on the far hash mark, moving left to right in the fourth quarter of play. Out of the shotgun now, quarterback Braden Wright. Wright looking in trouble, trying to get rid of the football. Is that called an interception? No, incomplete.
Oh, I thought Andrew Hayes had that.
Hayes thinks he had it too. He's going to appeal here.
The ball, I mean, Freeman hit the right as he threw it, but man, I thought Hayes had that.
I did too. Well, it's going to be a punt. Fourth down and 8 from the 17-yard line. Get this, guys. This is only the second punt of the day for Northwest Missouri.
Can't really tell from the replay if he got that or not. The other punt was the first drive of the game.
Hohensee, the starting quarterback, is also the punter, so he has to come back in. High spiraling kick, but not that long. So Ouachita, Jeff, will have good field position at its 42-yard line.
Yeah, the Tigers are trying to put together a nice fourth quarter here. Got a touchdown on the last possession. They have the ball back with good field position this time.
Not going to win it, but they would like to finish strong at least, especially for these seniors who have given us so many thrills in recent years. Ouachita has won 4 of the last 5 Great American Conference championships. That's pretty stunning when you let it sink in, Richard.
It really is. And these seniors, there's several guys out there that have 4 conference title rings. One of the most successful, if not the most successful, senior class in Ouachita history.
Let's feed T.J. Cole and see if he can finally get a long one before his career is over. Pass is tipped and then caught on the tip at the 45-yard line by Justin Dean. Dean was just in the right place at the right time.
He was, and they gave him his forward progress. He was pushed back to about the line of scrimmage, but he caught it at about the 46-yard line.
4-yard gain, as it turned out, on a tip pass.
You'll take it that 4 any way you can get it, but that was not a pretty 4.
No, but like you said, today, take it any way you can get it. Second down and 6, Ouachita working from its 46. Riley Harms rolling to his right. It is dropped. My goodness, down at the 41-yard line, and that's something you'll rarely see from Connor Flanagan. That was a good pass, Jeff. That was just a drop.
Yeah, dropped right into his chest, and he didn't hold on to it. We never see that from Flanagan, but he may have been looking for which move he would make after the catch.
I think that's the easiest catch he's had all year, and he just dropped it. He let it come to his chest instead of getting out there and catching it before it got there and kind of bounced off of him.
That's the kind of day it's been for Ouachita. Empty backfield, trips to the right side, 2 men to the left side. Out of the shotgun, now they bring in motion, T.J. Cole to block. Pass across the middle, caught at the 45 of Northwest Missouri. Connor Flanagan held on to that one for a first down, and they'll move the chains.
Well, Riley Arms could realize when he brought T.J. Cole in motion, if you don't already know, that they're in just a straight man coverage, and everybody was within 2 or 3 yards of the line of scrimmage. I mean everybody except the one safety. And so I think he said, well, I'm going to trust Connor Flanagan to get free on the quick slant route, and he did, and that was an easy pitch and catch.
First down and 10 from the 45-yard line. Here is the pass caught at the 41. They're going to say the 43. That's only 3 yards, 2nd and 7.
Flanagan's starting to have success. Ouachita maybe starting to figure out a few things on defense or on offense against this Bearcat defense. A lot of all the starters still out there for the Bearcats on defense, but
yep,
they're moving the ball a little bit better now. It's those short, quick passing routes where they don't let the pressure get home to them.
On second and seven, we'll see if they pass it again. T.J. Cole set to the right of his quarterback. Fake to Cole, rolling right, Harms in trouble and throws it away.
Yeah, he was trying to get Tucker Sabot on a double move, but not really interference down there, just kind of ran into a player, and that just threw off the timing of that, and then there was nothing there, and he just had to throw that one away. Another third down. They went to Flanagan the last time, but everything's four down territory at this point, you think, in the game.
Yeah, absolutely. Third down and seven, ball at the 42-yard line of Northwest Missouri. Tigers most likely will be passing again on third down. Two wide receivers to either side this time. Ball set right in the middle of the field. Ouachita moving right to left. Fourth quarter of play. Harms again in trouble. Gets it off. Going deep down in the end zone. And it's double coverage and incomplete. And it's fourth down. Intended receiver that time, Tucker Swoboda. Good double coverage, Richard, by Northwest Missouri.
Yeah, I like giving him a shot down there, though. He makes that high catch a lot of times. Thought about going short, and it was covered up. And then just for a second, Swoboda had a step on the defender, and so he launched it down there. But the safety did a good job seeing it coming over to make that double coverage. And fourth down here for the Tigers. I think they're going to be looking back short maybe at Flanagan coming across the formation. Got to give Harms time because I think this will be a little bit longer of a developing play.
And he hadn't had time all day. Two receivers to either side on fourth down. Straight drop back. Got some time this time. And it is, incomplete. Almost caught on the tip as Washita's Chris Hightower came in there. But that will be a turnover, and it'll go back to Northwest Missouri with 6:46 left in the game.
Yeah, trying to get the ball to Flanagan. It got tipped, and as you said, Hightower made a diving attempt at it, but couldn't come up with it.
So Northwest Missouri will come back out, run some more time off the clock. People begin to flood out of the stands. A lot of them stayed longer than I thought they would, but such a pretty afternoon. Cool, but now sunny. In Arkadelphia, might as well sit here and watch some football and watch a team that I certainly think is capable of winning a national championship in the Bearcats of Northwest Missouri. First down and 10, ball from the 41-yard line now. They'll just keep it on the ground. Good running room up the middle. Out to the 49-yard line. Gain of 8 on the play, second down and 2.
Trey Proctor with the tackle for the Tigers. And I think the Bearcats are going to be keeping it on the ground here. 6:30 left to go in this one.
And a 40-10 lead. It has been total dominance today by Northwest Missouri State. Second down and 2, ball at the 49, set on the near hash mark. Two men to the left, one man to the right. Give on the ground again, looking for running room, not finding any, and not going to be any gain this time. Good job that time by Ouachita. Couple of Tigers there leading the pursuit that time was Trey Proctor, the sophomore out of Bronson, Texas. No gain, third down and 2. Ball is at the Northwest 42, Bearcats moving left to right, set on the near hash mark. Leading 40-10, clock now all the way down to 5:35 left in the football game. Northwest will play the number one team in the country, Grand Valley State, up near Grand Rapids, Michigan, next Saturday. Give on the ground, one broken tackle, two broken tackles, first down and more. Down to the 44-yard line of Ouachita, and they'll move the chains.
Dante Gibson came in and tried a knockout shot with the shoulder, but didn't wrap up, and the Bearcat running back saw him coming, was able to spin off of him. As you said, that was Rowie, and he is able to get that first down. He'll check out of the ball game now, but first down, and that clock will keep moving. 5 minutes left to go here in the fourth quarter.
Ouachita will finish 11-1 on the season, an undefeated regular season, another GAC conference championship, but more than met their match in the national playoffs today. Give on the ground about 8 yards that time. It is Tank Young.
Jackson.
The tank was rolling that time, Dr. Rude.
He was a good young player getting in some game at the action at the end of the game, and he comes in as one of their good young talents. This is a deep, deep team at every position.
Jax Miller on the tackle for the Tigers. I think he's going to – he had 10 after three. He may finish with 15, 16 tackles. He's been a tackling machine for the Tigers this year.
Second down and three. Ball at the 37-yard line. High snap. It is pulled down, but it's going to be very little yardage. In fact, they're going to say no gain on the play. And it'll bring up third down now for Northwest Missouri State. Clock really running now. We're under 4 minutes, 3:57 and running. Northwest Missouri State leading Ouachita by the score of 40-10. Third down and three.
That high snap, you could tell, Rex. That play never had a chance after that high snap. Ouachita was able to get back there. The handoff was a little late. So it's going to force another third down where so far the Bearcats have just dominated so far today.
Yep. Braden Wright now in at quarterback. Wright sends a man in motion right to left. Another high snap, but the running back's going to go. 10-5 into the end zone. Touchdown, Northwest Missouri. Touchdown, Robert Roy.
Talked about today, Ouachita's done a good job when they've been trying to go up the middle. This time, though, the linebacker's not at home as he broke through that first line, the line of scrimmage. There was nobody there. The secondary gone and able to trot on into the end zone for the easy touchdown.
On to attempt the extra point yet again, Cole Lammel, the sophomore out of Omaha, Nebraska. 3:25 left in the game. Lammel will try to make it a 47-10 Northwest Missouri State lead. Snap, hold, kick. It's good. Northwest Missouri 47, Ouachita 10 with 3:25 left in the game. Ouachita Football 2022 presented by Bisonite Springs continues from Cliff Ferris Stadium in Arkadelphia in 30 seconds here on the Ouachita Football Network.
Minutes, 25 seconds left in this football game, and Northwest has picked up another touchdown on a six-play, 59-yard drive. It is the Bearcats, 47, the Tigers, 10.
Bearcats will advance to play the team ranked number one in the country, Grand Valley State of Michigan. Ouachita has about 1,800 students. This school has 8,500. Grand Valley has over 24,000 students. It's a huge school. Here is the kick, going to be caught running backwards. Now deciding to run it out, Justin Dean at the last moment. Should have downed it. He would have had it at the 25. As it is, Richard, it's going to be the 20.
Yeah, he was shielding the sun, trying to make the catch on that one. You just let it bounce and go on into the end zone and take it out at the 25. But he was trying to make something happen, and Givens going to come out. Cole hadn't been out there since he came out earlier. I think he may have gotten a little shaken up, and no point in putting him back in the ballgame and hurting him. So I think Givens is going to stay in there.
So we have seen the end of the T.J. Cole era at Ouachita. It's been a lot of fun, hasn't it?
Yeah, he's going to finish his career number three all-time in rushing. That's impressive. Number two all-time single season. Number one all-time rushing touchdowns. One of the best running backs to come through.
First down and 10, ball at the 20-yard line. Harms has gone the different distance so far at quarterback for Ouachita. He'll roll to his right, looking to pass. Got a receiver at the 35, out to the 38-yard line goes Ouachita's Connor Flanagan. Another of those young players that we'll have back, Jeff, he is a sophomore out of Fayetteville.
Yeah, both Harms and Flanagan are sophomores.
Yeah.
And they've seen tremendous amount of success this year. We're going to see a lot of passes from Harms to Flanagan the next 2 years. It's going to be a key to Ouachita's success.
That'll be a first and 10 at the 38 after an 18-yard gain. They come out of the pistol this time. Kendall Givens set behind his quarterback, Riley Harms. Harms looking to pass again, coming near side. and went mix up with his receiver. One went one way, the pass went the other way, wasn't near anybody. Tucker Swoboda was the closest man over there.
Well, that sailed on him because he got leveled, and he is slow getting up.
Yeah, they probably ought to get Livingston in there at quarterback.
He's taking some hits in this one. As he got leveled as he let that one go, and that's why it really just sailed on him there. Never had a chance.
He hadn't had any time all day. Ouachita has been beaten on both sides of the line of scrimmage, frankly, this afternoon. Out of the pistol, he'll stay in there. Harms looking, throwing it to Kendall Gibbons coming out of the backfield. Gibbons makes a move at the 40. Stiff arms his way out to the 42-yard line. Kendall Gibbons.
That was a good catch by Gibbons.
Yeah.
That
after all of that, you only get 3.5 yards.
That pass was hot out there to him. That's one thing about Riley Harms. You never doubt his arm strength.
Third down and 7 from the 41. Clock down to 2:15. Ouachita trailing 47-10. On third down and 7 from the 41-yard line. Two wide receivers to either side. Harms passing deep. One-on-one coverage. And it is caught. Caught inside the 30-yard line by Ouachita's Tucker Swoboda. Again, another sophomore, Jeff. He's out of Bentonville West.
What a nice play. Man-to-man coverage deep down that sideline. Back shoulder pass. He got there in time, made the catch, contested. Swoboda's got an ability to catch the ball in the crowd.
They'll mark it at the 22-yard line. Clock running with a minute 42 left in the game. Harms sets up, passes out into the flats. Kendall Gibbons at the 20, forced out of bounds after a gain of 2. It'll be 2nd and 8. Now, by usual at this point in the game, Richard's gone down to the sideline. They do not allow on-field interviews for some reason in the playoffs. We will have, I think, a couple of the Ouachita players and Coach Todd Knight up here for a press conference that we will try to cover for you on the postgame show today, so you'll want to stay tuned for that.
Don't quite understand the NCAA rule on no interviews.
Me neither.
But we can't do it.
That's right. Here's Harms running. He'll go inside the 20 to the 16-yard line. Gain of 4 on the play, 3rd and 4 from the 16. Clock continues to run with a minute 20 left in the game. 3rd and 4 from the 16. Let's see if Ouachita can get one more touchdown on the board before the afternoon is over. And this 2022 season, which has just been a magical season for Ouachita, comes to a close. On 3rd and 4, Tigers moving right to left, set in the middle of the field. Harms, drop back. Forced out of the pocket yet again. Throws it down into the end zone. Too high, too far, and they'll have a 4th down play, Jeff. 4th and 4 from the 16. So last gas for the offense. If they don't convert here, Northwest will kneel out the final seconds.
Harms again slow getting up, but he's going to walk back to the field and lead his team on this 4th down to try to score one more touchdown.
He wanted to get Dean on the crossing route. They just flat out, the linebacker pushed Dean down. Just went hands to the back, pushed him down. I mean, they haven't called it much today, but you can't push the receiver down.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you can watch the replay. Anybody can see that. That just flat out pushed him down.
4th and 4, ball at the 16-yard line. This may be the final offensive play of the season for Ouachita. Looking, Harms got a receiver at the 15, so they'll have a little more offense left. Inside the 10, down to the 8-yard line, Connor Flanagan.
They sent a receiver inside, and Flanagan really just did not move from his wide receiver spot. And I think that was a little bit of a busted coverage because the Bearcats weren't out there at all. And it was easy for him to make that catch and walk, basically kind of just jog up the field to get that first down. 47 seconds left to go in this one.
1st down and goal from the 8-yard line. Harms sets up, throws, got a receiver at the 2-yard line, Connor Flanagan. Clock running, 40 seconds, 30 seconds, 37 seconds, I mean.
Ouachita's got 3 timeouts still, so they can stop the clock still if they want
yep.
to.
2nd and goal from the 2. Let's see if they get it on the ground here. Kendall Gibbons. Nope, they're going to let the quarterback go in. Riley Harms, did he get there? Did not. Inside the 1 with 17 seconds left.
Ouachita's
and they are going to use a timeout. 47-10 in favor of Northwest Missouri State. Ouachita Football 2022, presented by Visit Hot Springs, continues from Cliff Harris Stadium in Arkadelphia in 30 seconds here on the Ouachita Football Network. Want to get one last touchdown here before this season comes to an end. It is going to be the direct snap over left tackle and into the land of milk and honey goes Kendall Givens, the sophomore from Little Rock Christian.
Fitting the year ends for the Tigers with a rushing touchdown. They've been so good at that all year, and really just when we saw the draw, Rex, we knew this was going to be a tough matchup because Washington likes to run the ball, and
yep,
the Bearcats like to stop the run.
Yeah, and they are second best in the country, and this will be, I believe, their sixth consecutive victory after a couple of losses early, and I think they've put it together. I would not be surprised if they went up and upset Grand Valley State next week. Would not be surprised. I'll be checking the score, I can tell you that much. Kick is up, and it is good. 10 seconds left in this one. Northwest Missouri State 47, Ouachita 17. Ouachita Football 2022, presented by Visit Hot Springs, continues from Cliff Harris Stadium in Arkadelphia in 30 seconds here on the Ouachita Football Network.
Kicking off for Ouachita, number 97, Dax Jaggers, deep to receive for Northwest Missouri, number 7, Kashawn Griffin, and number 25, Tank Young.
11 plays, touchdown coming from Kendall Givens. 10 seconds left in the game. It is Northwest 47, Ouachita 17.
And so Ouachita will kick off, and Northwest will have to kneel it one time, and they'll move on in the playoffs, and again, another magical season for Ouachita will come to an end. Ball will be fair caught down at the 12, so unless something just really crazy happens, 47-17 is going to be our final score this afternoon as the Ouachita season comes to an end. Stay tuned to the Southern Bank Corp Tiger recap. We will have try to get the Ouachita players and coach in the news conference. We'll have the final stats. We'll have scores from around the country, and we'll have some final comments on a season in which Ouachita went 11-0 in the regular season and won another great American Conference championship and won another Battle of the Ravine, losing Clark Yarborough after that first game and then running off 10 straight victories to finish 11-0 on the regular season. They will finish 11-1 overall as the clock runs out. We miss you, Clark Yarborough. This great season has been for you. That concludes the ball game, but the Southern Bank Corp Tiger recap will begin in 2 minutes here on the Ouachita Football Network, presented by Visit Hot Springs.
All year long, and we'll see you 2023 for another championship campaign of Ouachita Tiger football.
Flanagan. To the Comet Slam! Ouachita is back